we have a finals to finish this evening off with, and it's no other players than ThorZaiN versus TLO, and they're sitting right here. They're talking a little about their friendly banters, and they were asking about should we veto a map, and he's like, yeah, I'll meet at this one, right? And he's like, yeah, that's a good map, yeah, sure. So they're having very friendly banter here, picking up out the maps together. I don't know, that's nice. We're actually building a bridge between your two countries. That's cool. Not a physical bridge. That would be madness. Anyway, so with that, we're going to start finishing this event off. We're going to have the finals. And if you enjoyed this, there's been a lot of technical failures. But hey, we're going to produce this again in some near future. Cosmonova has been very interested in doing this. And we want to up the technology to actually get all the kinks, iron them out, and then pull this together into a perfect production. So next time, this is going to be sweet. But if you like this and you like StarCraft and you want to play against other people, no matter how good or bad you are, or and you are studying or you've ever studied, if you've ever studied, as long as you still have an email to your university of any sort, then sign up for University Star League Season 2. It's going to be absolutely epic. The events are not all going to be this physically big, but they're going to be mentally big. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. I love you too. I love you too. So this is going to be, it's going to be awesome. It's going to be huge. We're going to have weekly costs of what's happening in the side of the tournament. And after the first part, we're going to pick off the people that really are put into the top bracket of the tournament and get them to duke it out on their Grandmaster Master level. And then for anyone else who wants to join in and play people on their own league, the lower bracket is going to be separated into the different divisions as well, into the different leagues, into bronze, into silver, and so forth. So you're going to get to play people of your own skill level, and there's going to be final in each of these leagues. So I really recommend to join into the join the tournament. It's going to be www.unisl.se is the webpage you should go to, and you press the sign up button. And with that, I'm just gonna finish off, and I'm gonna leave off to Queenie and the player interviews for the finals.
Thank you, guys. So we're back for the last pre-game interview before the grand finals, and I have a question for you, ThorZaiN. As we saw that TLO has a very solid CVT. Do you feel confident in your TVZ?
Well, I wasn't really watching the games, so I don't think his playstyle matters. It's just like I'm too good to lose to him.
Well, TLO, do you have anything to answer to that?
That's just ridiculous. Come on.
All right. Well, as this event is getting closer to an end, is there any events we can look forward to seeing you in? Any upcoming tournaments or something similar? TLO, why don't you start?
Well, I'm going to be going to IEM New York, basically right after this. And then there's Home Story Cup, always, and DreamHack Winter, to which I qualified, unlike other players present.
Ouch. He's an hard act to follow. You don't want to talk about any upcoming events? All right.
I'm sure you'll go to Home Story Cup, maybe, if that schedule fits. He's going to Home Story Cup, maybe. I don't
know
yet.
Round of applause for that. Well, guys, keep your eyes peeled. So this is a charity event. I would like to talk a bit about your charity that you've chosen. ThorZaiN?
You go ahead.
So I picked an organization called Plant for the Planet, and they're really cool. They are basically planting trees. And they've already planted 13 million, billion, I mean, and their goal is to eventually plant 1,000 billion trees, which is very ambitious, but also awesome. And it was founded by an 8-year-old in 2007, and it's really children who are like doing all the planting, doing all the work, you know? And which is cool, because you know, if we want to save the environment, it's important that you know future generations are aware of that.
But please don't support children working, though. That not very good. What about you, ThorZaiN?
I picked Naturskyddsföreningen, which is a... like, to be honest, I've never really been... I don't know much about charity, so when I... I'm just gonna say it, like, when I found out that I was gonna pick a charity, I was like, okay, Google, charity organizations. And then I checked through, like, maybe 10 of them. I've always been very passionate about nature, and, like, I want to make sure that we preserve a lot of it, or most of it. And then I kind of just, like, looked through those kinds of charities and checked their agendas and, like, what they're up to, and I ended up with the Naturskyddsföreningen.
Well, that's some pretty good charities you've chosen, both of you. So shall we get these games going? Gentlemen, please shake hands and proceed to your booths. Over to you, casters.
Oh, they're coming to us now.
Yeah, and we are live. Welcome to the UniSL event here from the King of the Dome at Cosmonova. I'm Mr. Beck Sample here with Sembler. How are you doing, man?
I'm doing great. This is...
Everyone is doing fine here in the studio, and we are ready to get started with the finals. It's going to be EG ThorZaiN versus Liquid TLO, and it's going to be really awesome. I mean, how are you feeling before this game?
This is going to be great, man. We couldn't have expected a better finals out of this event. To be honest, TLO and ThorZaiN, both the favorites. When you looked at the four players that were lined up, Sho had a great chance at it. Slivko, great chance as well. But to have TLO and ThorZaiN right here in the finals, and actually we're now, you know, on camera as well. Hello, everybody. But to have these guys in the finals, we couldn't have asked for a better one. In a best of five as well, a TVZ. And, you know, going on throughout the last couple of weeks, actually, we've had the Fragbite Masters unveiled, and TLO's been competing. So we've seen quite a bit of out of him as well. He crushed Morrow in the round of 32, showed some very interesting mechanics in his TVZ style. So that's really the reason why I'm looking forward to this matchup. I want to see TLO and what he brings out here in this matchup versus ThorZaiN.
Absolutely, and we could say actually in TLO's series versus Sho that he didn't really bring out anything too weird. He just played the standard game and was able to, like, just in a solid macro transitioning into Hive early, he was able to just overwhelm Sho, even though it's usually the turn that overwhelms the Zerg with that big 3-base bio style. So we could say that TLO actually played, he didn't play this aggressive, creative game that he's known for, but just a solid macro game and was able to take out Sho, who is frankly a really, really good TVC player. So it's... Yeah, TLO has really been showing some strength. Do you think ThorZaiN has what it takes?
I think that ThorZaiN is definitely going to be a stronger opponent than Sho. And, you know, despite the fact that Sho and his recent endeavors, you know, he's managed to beat Life, one of the best Zerg players in the world. We weren't able to see the same performance out of him today. ThorZaiN, however, a very strong Terran, one of the best Terran players in Europe, hands down. So TLO, he's already admitted this. He's like, okay, you know, ThorZaiN is definitely the strong opponent here. I'm going to have to be very careful with how I go about this. But I still think that we're going to have something to look forward to from TLO's match. He's got such a strong mechanical ability in his game to be able to drop creep every which way. Like, I've never seen a map so covered in creep when TLO, you know, than when TLO has been playing. So I'm really interested. I mean, as far as TLO is concerned, I'm kind of, you know, fanboying a little bit. But I'm always interested to see what he brings out.
Absolutely. It's going to be really interesting. And just looking at that whirlwind game against Sho, he just went for the six queens. So something to definitely keep our eye out for in this game is how many queens is TLO building. Yeah. If he goes up to six queens, he's going to go for the real macro game, just spreading all the creep everywhere. But if he goes for the four queens, maybe he wants to go into a faster lair, maybe the faster tech.
You know,
we'll see.
You know, I mean, obviously we're hyping TLO quite a bit, but I mean, this is the guy who was dropping hatcheries across the, you know, middle of the map, canceling them, and then having a queen underneath to drop creep tumors so that he could get his creep across the map faster and take his opponent by surprise. I mean, he's the kind of guy who can pull out these odd strategies that we don't see too often, seeing as how, you know, now that Heart of the Swarm has been out for quite a while, it's become a little bit more stable as far as what we can expect out of these matches. The players have figured out all the tricks that have come with this new expansion. TLO is still capable of surprising us, so he's always a very interesting player. On the other side, ThorZaiN, a very calm player. You know, he always really takes his time, executes his builds, executes his strategies, but does so in his own time. Never really rushes anything, never really takes you by surprise. He's very much the slow and methodical, I am going to, well, basically spoon you to death.
Absolutely, as you said, he's like just a methodical, patient, very experienced player. He's just going to be able to, I mean, he's not going to be throwing away units. He's not going to be trading Hellions for drones, for example. He's just going to be massing up his army, going for the big push, clearing out the creep, and then just going for the big mid-game push and try to take map control from there. I mean, just as you said, a solid mechanical player. That's ThorZaiN in a nutshell, pretty much.
No, there's no doubt about it. So, I mean, both of these guys, it's a TVZ and it's a best of five, and we're starting on Belshire Vestige as well. One of these maps that we've seen quite a bit, a fairly balanced map as far as the players are concerned. It does come up quite often in series, best of three, best of five. Belshire Vestige always pops up. What do you think we can expect to see out of both of these players already on this fairly balanced map to start things?
I would expect maybe a Reaper opening out of ThorZaiN because it's not a bad map for Reapers. You can pop in and just try to get the full scout of the Zerg base and then just maybe kill a drone or two if you're really, really lucky. But I think Tilo should have his micro on point. But anyway, you can kill a drone if you're lucky. But yeah, Reaper expand would be my guess for ThorZaiN's opening. And just going to two Reapers into a lot of Hellions from there, it's a great build. I think we're going to see that from ThorZaiN on this map.
Well, I wouldn't be surprised, as we are getting into the lobby now, guys, so don't doubt it. You know, we're not you know, just taking our sweet time over here. The players are getting into the lobby. They are ready. They're in their booths, as you guys saw just a minute's time ago. So we should have this first match underway, but this is, of course, with all the money riding on it. This is the finals. It is a best-of-five series, and as we've heard, you know, TLO, he knows about charities. That's his kind of thing. You know, he's one of those guys out there who meant to make a point. He wants to truly leave a mark on esports, leave a mark on the world. This is a guy with a vision. ThorZaiN is a med student. And, you know, I don't know. You know, he doesn't really have a charity or anything like that. He was just like, okay, I'm going to Google one, and then we'll go with that. That's great, too. But I mean, you know, there is quite a bit of money on the line here as far as, you know, which charity is going to get its donation today.
Absolutely. I mean, I think that they've both picked quite similar charities. I mean, playing trees and protect nature, that's almost the same
trees
thing.
Trees are
I guess.
Great. Trees we need and nature, oxygen that's and all like that jazz, you know?
Yeah,
breathing
I think so.
Is a cool thing. I like that. I enjoy breathing.
I think so.
Yeah, man. I didn't quite catch what ThorZaiN's charity was, though.
It's like Naturskyddsföreningen. It's like protect nature. Protect nature.
Okay.
I mean, like, against environmental destroying things. I mean, just protect the environment and nature. I think that's pretty much it.
Oh,
so
okay.
It's
so
quite similar charities.
Similar charities. One is planting trees, and the other one is looking to protect the trees that are already standing.
Exactly.
Right.
So that's going to settle who you want to cheer for. I mean, is the TLO ThorZaiN? Do you want trees to be planted or trees to be kept alive?
Yeah, we've already got too many trees. There's quite a few of them out there.
Actually,
up space.
In Sweden, there's a fuck ton of trees.
Yeah, there's got
like
a lot of trees.
What the fuck is trees everywhere? I mean,
but dude, there's so many trees. It's great, man. When you drive around in Sweden, it's beautiful. It's a soul-searching
you think
experience.
The trees are beautiful? I mean, when I'm going
so.
To like train or right. something in the woods, like, there's fucking trees everywhere. I think it's terrible.
But it's great. Okay.
How is it
a difference of perspective, you see? It's a difference of perspective. Because I come from Los Angeles. It's a big city.
Oh, yeah.
Not
that's
a
true.
Lot of trees. So for me to come to Sweden, all of a sudden I'm driving around. There's trees everywhere. It's an experience. I see green, you know, the color green. I'd forgotten what that looks like. So for me, driving in Sweden is awesome. It's amazing. There's so many trees.
And me coming from the Swedish countryside, it's like, well, there's
like
trees here.
Yeah,
well, fuck.
There's too many trees. Get me buildings. Get me asphalt. Get me cement. I want that sort of stuff.
Yeah,
so
what,
you, want ThorZaiN.
Different.
You want ThorZaiN. So, you want his charity.
I'm
but
not
all right.
sure.
We'll go ahead and get into the match. Spawning up here in the top left corner of the map, our Terran player representing Team EG and the motherland, Sweden. It is ThorZaiN. There we have him. Fine gentleman. Bespectacled as well. We're brothers that way, you know?
Absolutely.
And he's looking very focused indeed. But his opponent spawning in the bottom right corner of the map, Belshire Vestige, it is going to be EGTLO. The Zerg player spawning with the blue paint job. But here we have him again looking focused, again bespectacled. But he's got the proper jersey on now. He's got the liquid jersey, and it makes me feel better.
Definitely. But you still introduced him as EGTLO, right?
Yes, I did. Well, I had to do that.
Okay, yeah.
I can't let it go. I can't let it go that he went back on his word and actually, even for a joke, went to EG.
Yeah, that's actually quite.
I mean, this
even
the guy,
though it's just for fun, it's still like almost a big thing.
But this is the guy who was saying, I would rather slit my throat than join EG a few months ago. So
yeah.
For him to be like even joking about joining EG, I was very scared for him. I was worried about Tilo. I was about to say we need to put him on suicide watch right away. Get his brother over here into his apartment and make sure he doesn't do anything drastic.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know
okay,
if
well,
it's like Johnny D, but well, it's still.
Well, as far as things are concerned here on the map, we already have, well, you know, TLO going for that fast expansion play. Doesn't look like he went for spawning pool, so he will be going hatch first.
Yeah, it's just
going
to be a 15-15. I think it's going to build another drone now and then go into the spawning pool. And
mm-hmm.
in ThorZaiN's base, it's just like I predicted. I'm the fucking awesome at this. It's going to be a Reaper expand. And just looking at the placement of its barracks, it's going to be be building an add-on and then walling in. So it's just going to be like a supply depot, mm-hmm. and I think it's a reactor and then a supply depot for the wall-in. So it's not just a normal wall-in. It's going to be building an add-on really fast in this barracks.
Well, it's interesting to see. I'm wondering if he... Well, he's currently waiting on the resources, you know, just now finishing up that gas collection unit. So he will be able to get some gas underway. And there we have it. The Reaper is actually in production. He's going to be getting across the map and getting that scouting information for ThorZaiN. Let him know what TLO's up to. In the meantime, we have the Overlord actually making its way out here onto the natural. Sees that there's no CC on the low ground. He's going to go ahead and poke up to the high ground and see if he can get some eyes on what's going on in ThorZaiN's base.
Definitely, and one thing that this Reaper opening does is that you don't get a Marine for quite a while, so this means that the Overlord can be very offensive with the scouting, but however, TLO doesn't want to risk it, so he turns around with his Overlord, but he's going to be able to scout that ThorZaiN is going for a quite late command center, and then he should probably know what is up.
Yeah, he's not going to be too worried about any aggressive plays here from ThorZaiN. ThorZaiN, he's got the 400 minerals. We'll see the CC go down right on the dot. He's going to go. He's really on top of his play right now, ThorZaiN. As far as TLO is concerned, he's getting the queens out. The Reaper is going to be making its way into his base. However, there are fourlings that are about to pop, though. They're going to make it in the nick of time, and he should be able to repel this attack fairly quickly.
If ThorZaiN gets one drone here, it's going to be really huge, but I think TLO's micro is going to be on point. I don't think ThorZaiN is going to get a drone, and yeah, there's the Reaper. It's going to be forced off. It's going to be really interesting to see. Yeah, TLO is actually queued up Queen in his main base. I don't think he's going to... I mean, I'm looking out for Queen in the natural as well. If he's going to go up to four Queens immediately, it's going to be a real big tell that he wants to go for like a big late game. And let's see if he wants to build a Queen at the natural as well.
Yeah, I mean, I'd be amazed if he didn't. There we go. We do have the two queens. The four queen play. And this is really solid. This is something that TLO does quite a bit, actually. We already have two Reapers out here, actually, for ThorZaiN. So he will have a bit of a punch. He's already trying to micro them, actually, trying to keep them alive. They do regen HP very quickly here in HOTS. So this is a very versatile unit already, ThorZaiN. Just keep an eye on him.
Yeah, he's just killed two Zerglings, actually, if you just look at the like hard facts of what he killed. But he's just been making TLO a bit uncomfortable. And behind this is also one for the director factor into the very early third command center. So he's just going to be going for the macro game and just poking in with his Reapers and probably be going to putting out some pressure with the Reapers as well as like 4 to 6 Hellions.
Yeah, exactly right. You know, he will be following it up with those Hellions. Barbecue is in order. But for now, at least, TLO kind of playing to his strengths, playing to his style. He's a man who focuses on getting his creep out. One of the first Zergs I saw actually binding creep tuners and making sure that he would hit that timing on the nose. So TLO, getting those extra two queens out, he will have, you know, the extra energy to put into creep tunivers, getting that creep spread out across the map.
Oh, ThorZaiN's actually going to lose the Reaper.
And that's a little bit unfortunate, as it did happen out here over in the main base for TLO. But in the meantime, in ThorZaiN's natural, we actually have those Hellions starting to gather. So he will be able to start making his way across the map with those and applying a little bit of pressure here at TLO's front door.
I mean, ThorZaiN just went into the main base and just scouted the main hatchery to see if it was turned into a lair and just went out, but lost it. And I mean, to scout for like a 6 to 20 lair, that would be super extreme early, an extreme early lair. So I think it's quite strange that they scouted so early, but anyway, here's the Hellions on the way, so losing that Reaper is not too big of a deal as it has the Hellions for the map control right now.
And the Hellions are going to get in here. They're actually going to do some damage to this Queen. The drone is going to stay alive. He goes ahead and throws it on an extractor as well, but this Queen is forfeit. She is not going to make it back home to the base. They get picked off, and already ThorZaiN coming ahead in that engagement. There's actually nothing here to save this extractor as well. He could very well lose the drone.
The TLO is actually going to up to 24 Zerglings, so that means like 12 drones is not made. So TLO is going to go up to a lot of Zerglings to just defend this, but meanwhile, ThorZaiN has the very early third command center. This is just mainly like a stall for ThorZaiN, just while keeping TLO busy in his base, he's been able to get up these command centers as well as a double engineering base. So ThorZaiN is really going for the late game here with a pretty early stim pack, actually.
And this is something we saw TLO actually do versus Show, is it not? That he went for this third base location right here where you usually expect to see the fourth or fifth base. He's actually going ahead and throwing his third, but again, he's going to go in here right as speed finishes. Nicely done. Going to pick off the Marines defending here for ThorZaiN. And this is a great opportunity for TLO to get in and do some pretty significant damage.
Yeah, absolutely. Here the Hellions come to defend, and actually just two SCVs were lost, but there's a huge amount of mining time lost, and as well as some mules. So, I mean, even though TLO didn't do the most amount of direct damage, that was quite an amount of indirect damage done.
Mm-hmm. He's coming up with some follow-up links as well. He's got to be a little bit careful. Doesn't want to donate these for free. He's going to pick off a Hellion, and again, the Lings continue the chase. They may get a second one as well, but it's not meant to be. The Flames will go ahead and eliminate those. And in the meantime, this is hardly any investment worth mentioning here for TLO. He's more than happy to give away these Lings. He doesn't really care too much about them, as he's got even the drone impersonator out here in the middle of the map, having a bit of an identity crisis. It's going to be floating its way home fairly quickly here.
Definitely just a misread, I think. But anyway, I think this is quite a cool tech order here for TLO. He goes for the Baneling Nest pretty early and to get the early Centrifugal Hooks and as well as the early Spire. He actually went Spire and Baneling Nest before starting +1/+1, so quite late upgrades, but early Lair Tech.
Yeah, early Lair Tech. He's going to move on into that Spire. This is what we saw him do versus Sho, and this is also something that we saw him do versus Morrow in the Fragbite Masters, really relying on this upgraded Ling with the Muta to back it, the Baneling. You know, he loves this sort of style. In Morrow game, however, he did have creep pretty much spread across the map, so a little bit behind on that, but still making good headway with that creep as far as he's concerned. He does have the three bases just cranking away right now, so his economy is very healthy. And I'd have to say that TLO perhaps in a little bit of a better position right now.
He's just going to have four queens right now, so just one extra spread creep, so not the biggest of creep spreads, but even though it's going to be, but it's going to be pretty big. At least there's actually the armory on the way, as well as +1/+1. So ThorZaiN is going to be actually ahead on upgrades, which is pretty huge for the turn. Mm. So, I mean, ThorZaiN is going to have a lot of big timing windows when he has like +2/+2 finish. It's going to be a big timing.
Yeah, but we have the Mutas making their way out onto the field now as well. 9 in production as well, plus the +1, obviously, ranged upgrade here, or the air damaging upgrade. Regardless, words, they will be dealing quite a bit of a punch here, these Mutas, and he's going to actually need it here, as it does look like ThorZaiN shaping up to go for that Marine, head of Medivac, and Mine composition.
Absolutely, just a standard MMM here. And ThorZaiN's actually stemming in. He wants to clear out the creep right now, and with actually these 5 Hellions are a big deal, because any Surglings or Banelings can't really do a lot against this army, so ThorZaiN's pushing back, but that's actually a lot of Banelings for TLO. He's going to be able to push this back.
Yeah, but again, with the phenomenal creep spread here by TLO, he should be able to get in position. Already a good connect there, managing to pick off about half of those units. So ThorZaiN's push already lost quite a bit of punch, and now the Muta's flying in as well. The Banelings connecting left and right, and we have a very easy cleanup here for TLO.
It is a small amount of Marines here for ThorZaiN. He has to pull back right now, but actually a split against the Banelings, but these Mutas are going to be able to clean up definitely. There's 9 Mutalisks as well as 3 more on the way, so if TLO is just left alone to build up a huge Mutalisk count, it's going to be really tough for Aegis ThorZaiN, as the Mutalisks are just going to have the mobility.
Mm-hmm. And look at this double, actually, you know, on the fourth base location here for TLO. He's got his fourth base, but he's also got the macro hatch as well, so he's just throwing money around left and right, TLO, willing to make that investment to get that production up and running for himself. And it does look like he's got actually the Overlord speed as well. Something that TLO, he loves to do. He gets it nearly every match. Just focuses on making sure that those Overlords are going to be able to provide as much information as possible. But a great pick there. Manages to pick off those two mines, with those Mutas.
Absolutely. Really important thing to pick up the Widow Mines. ThorZaiN actually went for the Viking, who has been able to clear out an Overlord here at the third base of ThorZaiN. So this Viking could bring out quite a lot of value if he was able to shut down the Overlord, but it's going to be tough for these Mutas out.
Mm-hmm. And that, look and at this, just a handful of Marines as well. He is going to go for it. He's managing to make his way right in here to the natural. There is a bunker, but it's not a whole lot. The Baneling's getting into the mineral line as well, and ThorZaiN's in a bit of trouble here. Not too much to defend at home. The mine's getting picked off, and now TLO, he reigns the coup. He's sitting in the natural. He's going to clean everything up.
Well, he's just going to go for it here with the Mutalisk and the Surglings and the Banelings. Just blowing up the player, but blowing up SCVs and Marines as he wishes. Great bunker placement here at the third base, though, for ThorZaiN, so he's going to be able to hold for now, but huge damage done by TLO.
Yeah, fantastic job already by TLO. No mining happening on the natural as well. These SCVs are just sitting here. There's a handful of Marines. It's going to be enough, but the Banelings are morphing right here at the front door. The bunker is going to go down, and we have SCVs trying to repair the supply depot, trying to put up a bit of a wall to hold them back, but it does look like TLO is getting ready for another push.
The Banelings are going to be pushing through, and the SCVs don't do anything about the Banelings. Great split in the Marines, but it's not going to be enough against Surglings. The Mutas click with TLO, it's pushing through.
Yeah, this very well could be it. We have a great supply lead here for TLO. He's just sitting pretty full control of his opponent's base. We have Marines getting cranked out as well as Mines, but TLO just in a commanding lead right now in this match. Still not actually inflicting the killing blow. We do have ThorZaiN still holding on for the time being at least, but good damage being done.
Tilo's poking and prodding back and forward. That's wanting to like all in and lose his Mutalisks, but Tilo's poking in, and that's a lot of Mutalisks. +1 and +2/+2 is just going to finish in like 10 seconds, so Tilo needs to wait for that, and he's going to have a great advantage.
Yeah, he is. He's just cranking units out left and right. He's still got those fourth base running. A nice mine connection there on those Mutas, managing to pick off the one and bruise a couple others, and now he's going to go ahead and make his way over here to the third base, make sure that, look at all these mules. They've been dropped right here by ThorZaiN, but there's nothing here to defend. Just a bunker with four Marines. They get cleaned up. ThorZaiN trying to come to the rescue, but there's not a whole lot here to do it.
And as you said, meanwhile, while this is happening, TLO is on 5 hatcheries. It's cranking out Surglings, Mutalisks, and Banelings. He's just pushing forward and +2/+2 down, and there's actually the infestation pit. So he is not done with this. He wants to go into the hive tech, maybe to the +3/+3 and the Ultimate Cavern. So even though it's putting down a lot of pressure, it's not all in.
No, it's not. Exactly right. He started to throw down that Infestation Pit here, TLO. He's going to start making his way towards Hive and getting those higher upgrades. But he's still adding on Lings. He's still adding on Mutas. And he's got to be very careful about that. Tries to pick off a mine. It looks like he will barely get one. But there's so many Marines. He has to be exceedingly careful with how he goes about engaging these units.
Absolutely. The Mutas, with the attack upgrade, are great at just doing damage whether Marines or not, but without the Carapace, they're going to be really vulnerable. However, TLO is going to be able to get a lot of free Marines right here.
Oh, this is all practically everything here for ThorZaiN. He's 70 supply down and dropping, and there's just so much here for TLO. He rolls into the natural expansion. The Banelings will connect on those Marines.
GG
is called, and TLO goes up 1-0 in the series.
Well, delaying the Evolution Chambers, just going for the Spire, just going for the Bane List, and putting on a lot of pressure with, like, unupgraded Circlings of Bane Links, just showing that early tech is great, even though you don't have the upgrades. You don't need them.
No, he found that early off. Exactly right. You know, he found the opening, and he just continued to press forward and just expand on that advantage. He had the pressure rolling. He managed to get into the natural expansion for ThorZaiN, and all of a sudden he realizes, well, ThorZaiN doesn't actually have a whole lot here. I can kind of just set up shop and keep pushing at him and not let him get into that situation where he'd be comfortable and able to get back into this match.
Absolutely, and ThorZaiN was going for the early third command for the early Dublin engineering base, but they didn't actually get to matter that much because his production was just so late that TLO was just able to overwhelm him.
TLO's going over there patting him on the back, being like, nice job, bro. That's awesome. It's all right. Better luck in the next hang, huh?
Not sure if it's BM or if it's just BM.
Well, you know, it's just like, this is the best of five, dude. Don't give up hope. It's all right. I've just crushed you in the first game. That's all. You know, don't worry. You still got a chance. Yeah.
Maybe. I don't know. Yeah.
Well, I mean, as far as things are concerned here, TLO looking really fine. I mean, he looks like he's in great shape right now. His TVZ, he did say this is one of the matchups that he preferred.
Absolutely, and if we just think about this psychological game, I think ThorZaiN is playing, ThorZaiN is actually studying psychology, but just looking at this psychological game, I think TLO is just really, I think.
Is he becoming a doctor?
Doctor in psychology, maybe?
Yeah, actually, it's kind of the same thing, isn't it? Yeah. All right, well, go ahead. What was your point?
Well, I just think that, I mean, ThorZaiN is studying psychology, but I think the psychological advantage absolutely has to go to TLO after that first game. I mean, it wasn't just that TLO was able to win. It's just that TLO was the one putting on pressure for the whole game. Mm-hmm. I mean, ThorZaiN was, like, never even able to go out of his base without just getting his army destroyed.
Well, it didn't really feel like ThorZaiN was able to put any real pressure out. You know, he had the Hellions out on the map. He had the Reapers, but TLO never really seemed to be under any kind of pressure. He just, you know, okay, you're here, you set up shop at the third, at my usual third base location, the third base I would usually take, but all of a sudden I'll go ahead and just switch things up, take my third base at a different location. You never even get close to touch it, and no harassment coming out for ThorZaiN. He was, past that point, he was always on his side of the map, having to defend, having to be on the defensive, on the back foot. And TLO just never let him get any kind of equilibrium back. Just kept pushing until eventually ThorZaiN, he's a tall, skinny guy, tumbled over.
Absolutely, and I mean, ThorZaiN just opened up with two Reapers and like six Hellions, and what did he get? Like one Queen, maybe two Circlings?
Yeah.
I mean, it got like almost no damage with his early units. But anyway, we're actually loading into the second map here, and it's going to be Aklan Waste. So let's just get into the game because I'm really excited to see what's going to happen.
I am too. You know, I am really looking forward to this. As already, well, Aklan Waste is going to be the map here for the second map of the series. This is a best of three, by the way. The GLHF does come out from both of these players, and for now at least, in the bottom right corner of the map, we have our Terran player representing EG and the country of Sweden, the Viking himself. It is ThorZaiN.
Look at the Viking look, man.
He looks focused.
Don't get intimidated.
There's death in those eyes. TLO's got to be careful. Absolutely. But then again, we have the potential convict spawning up here in the top left corner of the map, playing for Team Liquid as our Zerg player. It is going to be TLO.
Yeah, looking really scary in this game. And it's going into Aklan Wastes here as a second map. I would think that if Belshire is an okay Reaper map, I think Aklan is actually a lot better. And judging by the supply depot positioning, I would guess it's just going to be a 12 racks, 12... No, it's actually just going to send back his SCV, so it's just going to be 14 CC. So just the commands of the first for ThorZaiN, who wants to throw it up a bit, don't want to get too easy to predict.
Yeah, you know, this is the cheeky style of ThorZaiN at the same time. You know, I'm sure they've played each other plenty on the matchmaking, on the ladder, on the in-practice matches as well. You know, these guys have got to be pretty familiar with each other's styles as already. You know, TLO on the other side of the map, however, not going with the supply pool first. He's actually going to go for the hatch first play here. So, similar styles coming out from both of these guys, similar styles. ThorZaiN going for the CC first, TLO going for the hatch first.
Absolutely, and ThorZaiN going for the CC first on the high ground, actually, not on the low ground. So he just wants to be safe. I mean, going for it on the low ground would mean you will be really vulnerable to like a six pull or something. But he just wants to go for it on the high ground to be really, really safe. And that maybe also goes to show that TLO has a psychological advantage. ThorZaiN maybe doesn't dare doing all this scary stuff that he would normally do.
It doesn't really seem like ThorZaiN's style. You know, he has shown in the past that he is capable of throwing the curveball and being like, I can get up in your face. I can be aggressive. You know, they do call me the Spoon Terran, but it just so happens that today in my back pocket, I've got a knife! And he goes at you. But it doesn't look like we're going to see that style today out of ThorZaiN. ThorZaiN, living up to his name. He's got his pudding. He's got his spoon. And he's content to just sit back and enjoy it for now at least.
Absolutely, and not the true Viking style right here. He just wants to go for the late game here, as it looks like, or just maybe for a big mid-game push, who knows. But just like sitting back, relaxing, enjoying himself, and like not putting too much pressure. I mean, TLO himself, I think he's just going to go for at least four queens as well, and just be sitting back himself. So yeah, just two circles on the way, so just taking some pressure and maybe taking this in longer towers. Just defensive play from both players here in the early game, I think.
Yeah, not really changing too much here. As already, you know, TLO just content right now to crank out the drones. He's got this SCV over here. ThorZaiN perhaps posturing, saying, hey, you know, there are some aggressive options for me open here. Maybe I'm going to try and catch you by surprise, drop a bunker. I don't know. But for now, at least, the SCV will make it away with its life. And these two Lings, you know, just going to kind of clear things up here for TLO. He wants to make sure there's no surprises waiting in the wings, and it doesn't look to be the case.
TLO looking really confident. No drone scout at all. Just goes in with the first Overlord, gets a scout of exactly everything. Sees the command center, sees the early factory. So TLO knows exactly what's going on without even sending out a drone. So I think he's in a great position right now. And actually against Sho, we could see him going for the Overlord speed in like all the games, I think, just for the Overlord scouting. I'm really excited to see, does he want to go for the Overlord speed in this game too?
Well, there's the third CC coming out here for ThorZaiN, but you're absolutely right bringing up that point. This is something that TLO does. He is one of these players who is not, he is willing to go ahead and invest that early, to make that early investment to pick up the Overlord speed, to get that additional information right off the bat. He loves to get Overlords in positions that are annoying for his opponent, dropping creep on the third, on the fourth, on the fifth, all across the map. We've seen TLO actually create creep highways just with overlords and then catch up with the queens who drop the tumors under him, etc. So this is a very versatile player we're talking about here. And as far as ThorZaiN is concerned, he has to be keeping so much in mind right now. He has to think, well, TLO's a very cheeky bastard and he could very well throw a curveball at me. Or he could play it straight up and simple.
But I mean, what curveballs can you really throw in a Zerg versus Terran matchup? I mean, I wouldn't expect TLO to go for some like big two-base aggression or anything. I don't think there's really anything he can do which would signal aggression. I mean, if ThorZaiN just go for the normal bias, I think TLO just has to play it standard. But, well, looking at the last game, I mean, TLO should be really comfortable just playing it standard in Terran Zerg. But there's actually the Roach Warren, so what am I talking about? We might be seeing some aggression right
this
here.
This is what I'm talking about, TLO. You can never predict this guy. He's a German. He likes to follow rules, but he creates the rules, you see. And the rules today appear to be as unpredictable as possible. As already, we have queens coming out. They're going to go ahead and duel it up with the Hellions. Just barely making it away with 2 HP there. And he's actually going to go ahead and send this one home, I think, and get it repaired. Doesn't want to give anything away for free here, ThorZaiN. But, you know, again, TLO, so on top of his creep spread, just keeping on top of everything, making sure that he gets his creep spread out so, A, he can see what ThorZaiN is up to, has that map vision, but also the speed boost to his units when on top of it.
Wow, 10 roaches on the way for TLO. This definitely signals not just a little bit of pressure. This is definitely some big, big pressure he wants to put on. He wants to be aggressive. He wants to shut down ThorZaiN and going for the early third command center as well as the double engineering bay. This is going to be a big serving Baneling Roach play. I mean, ThorZaiN is going to be in a really tough position against this.
Yeah, warms the cockles in my heart, mate. I don't die. I don't lie.
He sees this Roach right now, actually. So this is a big tell for ThorZaiN. He knows what's going on right now.
Yeah, but I always wonder if like TLO is like, well, I know you have this. You're playing standard as could be. At this point, what do you have at home to defend? We already see two bunkers going down. The panic bunkers being thrown. There's a couple mines here as well that could be useful here for ThorZaiN if he puts them in good spots, good positions. But we have the Banelings morphing here at the front door for TLO. He is getting ready to come a knocking.
Absolutely. I mean, ThorZaiN has the third commander and the double engineering base, so if he holds, it's going to be in a great position. But I think the odds of him holding are really, really low. The roaches are pushing in right now.
Yeah, they're already going to work on the bunker, and there's no SCVs here to repair. They stop midway. The roaches are in on the natural. There are so many Banelings as well. interesting connections there with the Banelings, but he's still able to do maximum damage. There's one bunker left, but it is not going to stand for long, and TLO looks like he's just going to roll right through ThorZaiN.
Wow, he's just showing who's the boss. He's showing who's the one who has the lead in this game. He just puts on the aggression with the Roaches, with the Serglings. He's just streaming in from all the angles. Speed is done, and he's going to be able to push down this last bunker. I mean, I think TLO got this.
Yeah, he is all over it, man. There are a couple mines here, but two more, and they are on cooldown. There's still a handful of Roaches. The supply depot hasn't been raised, but still, TLO has set up shop in his opponent's natural base. There is no mining done here, and as far as the economy is concerned for ThorZaiN, something he loves dearly, he's going to have none of it this time around.
Wow, will ThorZaiN actually hold? I didn't believe this. I mean, there's a lot of Serglings and Roaches to do for TLO.
He'll hold. Wow, but he ThorZaiN lost so many SCVs. Well, so much damage was done to him at this point that TLO's like, yeah, sure, you're alive. You're hanging on by a thread, buddy, but he's in full control of this match.
I mean, ThorZaiN is behind in workers, sure, but just look at the upgrades. I mean, 1-1 is done, pretty much. So he's like a whole upgrade ahead of TLO, which is, I mean...
What's with that Sporecrawler back there? That's interesting. I mean, he's got the third CC. That's the thing with ThorZaiN. He's lost quite a few gatherers. He still has the third CC, so he will be able to repopulate fairly shortly here. TLO, he made the investment in the early aggression, but he's still in a decent position here. He's got his third base up and running. He's making the drones to go ahead and get that populated, and he will have the units to go ahead and deal with any kind of early aggression already coming out here by ThorZaiN. As we see, the medevac gets picked off, and now TLO stabilizing fairly handily. He's got a healthy supply lead going into this, and now it's just a game of where does he want to take it from here?
But ThorZaiN is just going to the +2/+2 with the Evolution Chambers actually just now finishing for TLO. So if ThorZaiN just turtles and waits for 2-2 and is pushing out with the when the 2-2 is done, I think he has a great shot at doing some damage. But, well, it's like 160 seconds till that's done, and the creep spread by then, it's going to be like at ThorZaiN's natural, I think.
Yeah, mines are such a cheeky unit, but they're going to go ahead and... He's got quite a healthy unit counter them as well here, ThorZaiN. But still, TLO... Going to work, ThorZaiN, yeah, exactly right. You know, this is something that TLO does quite a bit of. He's going to get that Overlord in position on the fourth base, start dropping creep over there. He's going to get one over on the fifth base location, get, you know, creep going there as well. And really just looking to get as much vision here for TLO. His creep spread already moving across the map. I have to say, though, ThorZaiN, with the hold, he is in a pretty healthy position going forward.
I mean, I think ThorZaiN's position is actually pretty decent. I mean, TLO is actually forced to go for Roaches right now. I mean, he's going to go up to like 16 Roaches with Glial Reconstitution, but he's not going to have the upgrade. He's going to go for the melee upgrade. So I don't think TLO is in a great position. No Spire in sight for a long time. He's just going to go for a Roachling Baneling right now. And I mean, I don't know, against well-upgraded Marines, it's going to be really tough for him.
It will, and with ThorZaiN's control as well, he could be in a great position on the defensive. TLO looks like he is going to be gearing up for a bit of pressure here. As you can see, you know, we have the Roaches in production with the Baneling speed and the 1-1. He may very well wait for that 1-1 to finish up. But here, again, something that TLO does. Drops the creep, gets the queen right up under it, and gets a little bit of a head start here on the high ground with this creep spread.
Absolutely, but this Viking is actually worth its weight in gold right now, picking up Overlords left and right and just denying TLO the map vision he needs. There's the Drilling Claws on the way for ThorZaiN, who's actually gone up to a lot of production right now. He's at 6 barracks and 2 factories, all with add-ons, so he's producing a lot of mines, a lot of marines, but, well, who knows if it's going to be enough against the Roaches of TLO. I mean, I don't know, what do you think? Mass Roach versus Marine Mine, who has the advantage, really?
Yeah, but as soon as this fight's about to go down, TLO is going to start swelling up with some Lings as well. He's going to have the Banelings in the mixes, and with those on the field, it's upgraded Banelings, 1-1 Banes. As the +1 has just finished here for TLO, for Carapace and Melee, the Roaches are going to have the +1 Carapace to work with, but no ranged upgrade. So, I mean, the Roaches, I feel, are going to be there more to be like the tanky big brothers while the Banelings do the work.
But 2-2 is done for ThorZaiN, and +1 vehicle is just going to be done as well. So if he just starts the +3 armor, I think ThorZaiN is going to be a great late game position as long as he just can just clear out some of TLO's creep. But because if he doesn't clear out the creep, TLO is just going to have free map packs, free map control. I mean, I'm amazed that TLO hasn't taken a fourth base yet.
Yeah, exactly right, actually. That's a good point you make. No fourth base for TLO, so still relying on this third base economy. This is kind of like the all or nothing, it feels like. Either I kill him right here and now, or I'm going to be in too much trouble to really, you know, be worth to be... It's not going to be worth pushing on with this map.
I mean, it is 43 Roaches to 44 Marines, so, like, 1-1 Roach to Marine, a Roach should win, like, no matter what. But it's still 2-2 Marines against 1-0-1 Roaches. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's the upgrade advantage is definitely in ThorZaiN's favor, but TLO might just have too much. A third is a play ahead.
Yeah, he's already going to move down here, and he's actually going to show his hand. Actually, now we have ThorZaiN seeing just how many Banes there are, how many Roaches there are as well. TLO running a couple Roaches in, hoping to bait some
but
mine
look
hits.
At that Widowmine count. That's like 16 Widowmines. That's, I mean, wow.
There's no living through that.
I mean, if he just rolls in with Banelings and Roaches and hopes to be able to tank up that, I mean, he's not going to be expecting 16 Widowmines, but he's going to go for it.
He's got the Overseers. He's flying them over, actually. He's looking to draw the shots. He's looking to draw the shots. He's already managed to clear up a couple of them. This is a lot of Widowmines for ThorZaiN, but there is so much here for TLO. He continues to press forward with these plus one Caravase Roaches, and there's just so much here for TLO.
But the bunkers are still left for ThorZaiN at natural. If he pulls the CVs, then it's a point with the repairs. But he's not pulling the CVs in time. And plus three is not going to be done for ThorZaiN. It looks like TLO just has too much.
He has too much. He's moving his way up into the main now, getting into the production line. This is exactly what he needs to snuff ThorZaiN right here and right now. Getting up into the main, he's got the Roaches. They're going to work on the racks. They're going to work on the reactors. And now TLO is in a bit of a great, I mean, he's in a great spot. ThorZaiN, however, with the drop in the meantime in the main base and at the natural as well, inflicting some damage. This is all or nothing for TLO.
I mean, TLO is so far behind upgrades, but it doesn't matter when you have like 40 Roaches in your opponent's main base, just camping in the production facilities. Is ThorZaiN able to clean this up? I mean, TLO sent some of his Roaches to the third base, so ThorZaiN might be able to clean it up, but it's going to be real tight, and he has lost so much economy right now.
Yeah, this is a really tricky position. I mean, he's got plus three attack for these Marines. They're doing so much damage, and now the plus three armor is about to wrap up as well. That's quite a hefty upgrade advantage going ThorZaiN's way. The other thing is that Roaches can't shoot up. So if ThorZaiN lifts his buildings, we could have a very tricky position here for TLO. But it does look like he's going to get chewed up in the end. The Marines taking the fight. The medevac's here to heal.
ThorZaiN holds?
Will be
what's happening? I mean, he was able to clean up that Roach army, and with plus three, plus yes, this is 3-3 Marines against the 2-2 melee and 0-2 ranged of TLO. I mean, ThorZaiN's a great position, and there's not even a Spire tech as for TLO, so if ThorZaiN just keeps on dropping, keeps on putting aggression with the 3-3 bio, I think he's in a great position, and he's just loading up a Doom Rep right now.
Yeah, what is TLO's gatherer count right now? Because we can see that he's got drones in production. He's already, you know, trying to get everything repopulated. He managed to save quite a few of the natural drones we could see there earlier. The third base is still cranking away. As far as the natural is concerned, though, pretty bare. And as you pointed out earlier, no fourth base here for TLO. He has nothing to fall back on after this. He's just cranking out units for now.
That was a three base all in. If you just take a look at the army supply, it's 85 for ThorZaiN. It's 33 for TLO. I mean, I think TLO, he's a great player, and that was a smart build. He just went for a big three base all in, and ThorZaiN was able to defend. So I think, I mean, for a long part of the game there, I think ThorZaiN was going to lose. But right now, I think that ThorZaiN just got this game in the bag right now. He is so far ahead with the 3-3 Marines. They're benefiting so much from the upgrades, and I don't think TLO is going to be able to hold that here.
No, it's going to be very difficult here. There's already this handful of Marines with the 3-3. They shred everything. They're already going to work, but they get picked up immediately. Going to drop them right here in the natural. And some good abuse here coming out from ThorZaiN, taking advantage of the high ground, low ground mix. A Banely connects, however, and does some pretty significant damage. But the majority of the Marines dropped right here on the third.
But this shows the importance of upgrades. Marines just benefit so much from the 3-3, so ThorZaiN is just going to be able to hold right now, and wow, this huge amount of medevacs as well. It just goes to show that TLO, man, I think maybe he needed some mutas earlier, but he's going to go into Infestors, and he's going to be producing a lot of queens, so he's not giving up by any means, but I think he's in a tough position right now with just now securing the fourth base, and this is the big push coming out of ThorZaiN in the middle of the map.
Yeah, absolutely, exactly right. We see him having trouble dealing with the push that's going on at his third base. In the meantime, we have the reinforcements making their way across the map, cleaning up TLO's creep, getting the mines down. This is going to be so insanely difficult for TLO to hold in time for him to get these Infestors out. He has three on the way with some great Bungles and Baneling connects. He could clean this up, but it's going to take a stroke of genius here on TLO's part.
Absolutely. I mean, he's busy dealing with the drop from ThorZaiN, but just look at the main push from him. It's just, I mean, TLO just has to diverse his forces in two different angles, but being 80 supply down as a Sir against the Terran, he's just in such a terrible position right now.
Yeah, this is this is just insanely difficult. There's not a whole lot more to say about that. ThorZaiN is just kind of cleaning things up in his own style. He's like, I'm going to take my time about this. I'm going to relish tearing you limb from limb, TLO, and he's doing it one finger at a time. Because TLO, I mean, you can just see action across the map right here. ThorZaiN is everywhere. He's sending medivacs everywhere. He has got so many medivacs that everything is almost getting individually healed.
I mean, that was just a 3-base all-in for TLO that just... It simply failed. I thought he was going to be able to break through, but ThorZaiN's micro was just too good. And now with the 3-3 Marines against the 2-2 of TLO, I mean, ThorZaiN's putting on the pressure, and TLO simply doesn't have enough.
Well, he manages to clean up the force on his third base. There's still a good drop here behind the mineral line. They're already going to work on these drones. There's a couple mines here as well. And still, we can see such a healthy count. But the GG will be called, and ThorZaiN evens up the series 1-1. And there's the smile. ThorZaiN is pleased.
Wow, that just goes to show you that, well, TLO, he knows how to mix it up. It might just be... I mean, game one, he just went for the stun macro game, going to the Mutas and the upgrades. But in this game, he skipped the Mutas, skipped the upgrades, just went for the big hatch-to-tech aggression, and it was enough, man. ThorZaiN's micro was too good.
Yeah, ThorZaiN on point. You know, he was able to split. He was able to defend and just barely hold in the end, despite the fact that TLO got up in there. You made a very good point bringing up the upgrades as well. As soon as he had just a handful of Marines together, they were just able to just roll through all of those roaches. And unfortunately for TLO, it meant his end. It meant he had no real future in this match. ThorZaiN was able to find his balance.
If I have to make a guess for this game, I think TLO is going to be skipping the roaches. I mean... They are very tanky, and they don't take a lot of damage from Widow Mines, but, I mean, it's going up against well-upgraded Marines. The Roaches don't really do much, so...
That was the thing. It was do or die, really. You know, it was the Hail Mary he threw there, and unfortunately, he kind of tripped and stumbled before he could catch the ball. So, that's the situation here. TLO now has to think what's going to be coming up here. Is I'm not quite sure if what our third map is going to be in this series, if that's going to play a role here or not.
Absolutely. I mean... I don't think so.
It's going to be Whirlwind, okay.
Okay, yeah, Whirlwind. So.
Whirlwind is a map that we've seen quite a bit of. Yep. A Zerg favorite map. And it kind of
you could say, yeah.
Well.
I mean, last time we see TLO against Terran on this map, he just went for the 6 queens and just... I mean, you have 2 queens injecting and there's 4 queens just spreading the creep all over the map, and it's just...
The last time I saw TLO play on this map, basically what he did was he spawned bottom left and then he walked a queen all the way across the map to plant a creep tumor under an overlord on Morrow's fourth base. So, yeah. TLO could have some fun stuff here on this map. It could be really interesting. But as far as ThorZaiN is concerned, what can we expect out of our Swedish champion here?
I mean, he has went for the early third command as well as the early double engineering base so far. So, I would guess he's going to do something similar. But if he wanted one map... to throw in something cheeky on, I mean, this wouldn't be a terrible choice.
Really?
Just go for like 11-11 at the Salonga Tower in the middle. It would require some balls, to say the least. But it wouldn't be terrible in this map.
We're
I mean,
fans of ballsy play, you know, and when they do go ahead and commit to the aggressive play, that is something that's truly entertaining to watch. But guys, we're loaded into the map now. We should be able to get things underway, and there you have it. You can see it as well. Right here, spawning in the bottom left corner of Whirlwind, we have our Terran player, the Swedish Hope in this match, ThorZaiN. The GLHF's coming out, but there he is, not smiling now, focused like a laser.
Yeah, just keeping those eyes on the screen, and I think he actually really wants to win this.
No, I don't doubt it. And already in the top right corner of the map, spawning here as our blue Zerg player, it is going to be Liquid TLO. And there we have him as well. Does look like he would shank ThorZaiN if he found him in a back alley, so I do hope that ThorZaiN, you know, is careful tonight. But tied 1-1 in the series.
Absolutely. And while I talked a lot about TLO having the psychological advantage after the first game, I think it's kind of swing back right now. TLO just put in the aggression, and ThorZaiN just showed, well, I can handle this. I have good enough micro, so you can't just straight up kill me. So yeah, I actually just think that ThorZaiN might have been taking some of that back right now, and TLO can't be too comfortable right now. I mean, he has to be keeping it up. However, on this map, I don't expect him at all to go for the same build as an Echelon Wastes. I don't expect Roaches, I expect fast Mythlisks.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised, exactly right. I wouldn't be surprised by that choice attack from TLO. We'll see where he decides to go, as he's already going to throw down that Natural Hatchery expansion. And it does look like ThorZaiN gearing up to do the same. He's sending the SCV right over here, and it looks like he's actually going to include this CC as part of the wall. Interesting choice, seeing as how Whirlwind's such a big map. He could very well throw it on the low ground.
Yeah, I mean, this is just safer against like a 6 or 7 pool, mm-hmm. which I don't believe he's expecting TLO to go for it, but just anyway, he wants to just go for the safe pool. That's just ThorZaiN style, and well, even though it's a big four-player map, he doesn't want to take the risks. So, yeah, anyway, talking about these cross spawns, actually, just spawning top left and bottom right, it's quite a big deal. I mean, the push distance for ThorZaiN is going to be huge, so this would absolutely just favor the guy with a more mobile unit composition. And if TLO goes to go just goes for Mutling Baneling, I think he's going to be having the more mobile composition.
Mm-hmm. No doubt about it. I mean, flying units, pretty mobile in their own right. They can, they're not really limited by the terrain. And Speedlings, Banelings with TLO's creep, they could really go to work. As I'm being blinded by a giant light cock, I'm going to be paying more attention to this map. And it does look like TLO's kind of starting tried and true. I mean, he's got, the queen's coming out now on the map.
Yeah, definitely, but he's actually making an interesting decision now, not sending out a scouting drone, just sending the overlords to the top left and the bottom right, but the overlord's not going to be scouting anything, so it's going to take a huge while until TLO actually gets a scout on what ThorZaiN is doing. However, I think that TLO is just going to be comfortable in ThorZaiN not doing anything risky or cheesy, so I think TLO is going to be comfortable, and here's the first two circlings and as well as the two queens, but I would expect TLO going for the four queens. What do you think?
I wouldn't be surprised. He's going to be looking to get that creep spread down early. I would really be surprised if he actually decided to cut that out of his match. This is something that TLO has been paying very close attention to. You can tell through a lot of his TVZ throughout the Fragbite Masters and also his recent matches that he focuses very hard on making sure that creep is out, that he has that map vision, that map presence granted by that, I guess it's like a living, goop. I don't know really what it is.
Maybe. And there's like tumors that can see.
Yeah, look at it. I mean, like it's rippling and everything. There's got to be a pulse somewhere. I guess it's coming out from the hatchery, but then you have the creep tumors that go down.
But how can the tumors see? Do they have like eyes or?
That's actually.
I've never been
up
in close contact with a tumor.
Then you'd feel horrible about walking on a tumor. You're probably causing the creep pain if you do that.
I don't know.
Like
what
the
you
most
mean
ridiculous tangent right now. You smoke some good shit. Yeah.
Sometimes, I don't know.
Alright, well already, ThorZaiN, he's got the 3cc play going out. He's actually going to go ahead and move right on up to Hellions as well. So, bit of the map presence going to be felt by him soon enough here, as once he gets those the roasty toasty Hellions out on the map, he's going to be able to, start limiting this creep spread by TLO, and just making sure that TLO can't get the Lings out onto the map too quickly. For the meantime, however, TLO opting for his third base.
Absolutely, and these Hellions are just going to be this is going to be to take map control, and something quite remarkable about ThorZaiN, he just threw down his third command center at Snatchel with TLO spotting it. I mean, TLO had Surgling Stand, and ThorZaiN was like, no, fuck it, I'm just going to throw down my command center. I don't care if you see it. You know I'm going to go standard anyway. So ThorZaiN just shows how comfortable he is in the macro game, just throwing down the third command center, letting TLO see it, he doesn't care.
Yeah, and TLO instantly responds. He gets that third hatch out. He just focuses on cranking out nothing but drones. He's got the two evil chambers on the way, so we should start to see, upgrades come into play. But for now, at least, both of these guys purely, content to just power up. Focus on getting out those gatherers. Focus on getting that economy running so that they can then crank the armies out and start clashing in the middle of the map.
Absolutely. Both players just got tabs on each other, knows what they're doing, and this is actually quite interesting from ThorZaiN's point of view. He's going for the second and third barracks as well as the starport, but no engineering base throw down yet, so this just points towards some kind of aggression, just maybe just going out and clearing out some creep. But anyway, he wants to be aggressive as he goes for the earlier barracks instead of the engineering base, which just goes down now, so he's going to be behind in upgrades, actually.
Yeah, that's an interesting point. Something that he's relied on quite a lot in the first few matches of this series. ThorZaiN putting him on the back burner, not paying too close attention to him. He's already got six Hellions out on the map. He manages to deny the creep for the time being, at least. Quick cancel there by TLO saves that one tumor, but we still have 2, 3, 8, 4 active tumors on the map. He's going to be pretty decent with that. As far as things are concerned, though, these Hellions not really able to do too much as far as, darting in, getting into the gatherer line, or anything of the sort. They're just kind of content to sit back for now, at least.
This is something I love from ThorZaiN. Just
what
sending out
is
the
this?
He's just sent out the four Marines to clear out some overlords and then pull back, but
look at the miscue, however. That is something pointed out there, by the way.
Oh, that's just a big mistake.
That's a big mistake. He's got plus
one
melee on the way.
And then it's actually just like 100 seconds in. So this is just really, it's going to be really far behind in upgrades just because of this one mistake. This is really huge.
That's very unfortunate. It's not something you see, actually. You do see it happen every once in a while, where a player will queue it up on the same structure, etc. But that's not something to expect out of TLO, so it's interesting. Perhaps a bit of a tell here that he's feeling maybe a little bit of the Viking heat.
Maybe. I mean, I don't know how much TLO crumbles under pressure, but this is definitely a sign towards that Maybe he's not on point, actually. So.
Well, I think you were right on the money, Mr. Bad Example.
Really?
TLO, he's got the Spire on the way.
Wow, yeah. So just with the how large this map is and how easily abusable it is with drops, just to look how short the air distance is from the third base to the main base, you can just like go with meta backs back and forward, so you don't want your Terrans to be able to abuse that for free. You want to go for the Mutalisks. And anyway, it looks actually like ThorZaiN is just adding on more barracks right now, as well as the armory for the 2-2, so... Well, ThorZaiN is going for the late game, where it looks like TLO is just going to go for the late game as well with his fourth base, so... not a lot of unusual things happening so far. Both players just macroing it up, pretty much.
Yeah, exactly right. You know, both players are just powering up. They're getting that economy rolling so that they can then start cranking out the armies. That's kind of the focus at this point as we approach the mid-game here. They're getting on into it. They're getting fairly comfortable. And now we get to see, well, who's going to strike first, as this has been fairly uneventful in the beginning of this match. I mean, Hellions kind of roasting creep tumors. Some Lings, you know, some Ling action at the third base for ThorZaiN. But that's pretty much all we've seen now. With TLO getting the Mutas out, he's going to start being able to get in ThorZaiN's face.
I mean, if ThorZaiN knew what's going on, he would definitely want to just move out to the map, scan, kill some creep tumors, and put some pressure on. But with TLO just going for that very aggressive building game, too, maybe ThorZaiN just wants to keep his Marines and mines in his base. He doesn't want to push out too far. But anyway, it seems like he just has a small task for some Marines as well as two medevacs just pushing out. So probably just wants to scan and pick up some creep tumors.
Mm-hmm. And yeah, exactly right. You know, try and limit this creep here for TLO. He knows that TLO fancies the goop. But now we have the Mutas actually making their way out here. They will be able to get revenge for the fallen overlords. They save this one. And avenge his brothers. That Viking is shot out of the sky. But in the meantime, at the fourth base, we have the double medevac play here by ThorZaiN. It's going to get cleaned up nigh instantly. TLO with the units there, reading his opponent's mind.
Yeah, and he absolutely knows what's going on. ThorZaiN was actually scanning there, knows what's going on. But actually, there is just a plus two carapace going down for TLO. So TLO is, while his evolution chambers were earlier than ThorZaiN's engineering base, he's still actually behind upgrades just because of that one mistake. So that's not good at all, obviously, but the Mutalisks, they're going to be able to put down some damage, I think.
Mm-hmm. I don't doubt it. They are going to be able to get up here and start doing a bit of damage as they dart for the natural. There are no turrets. ThorZaiN relying on mines for defense, relying on the positioning of his army. That's not going to matter here, as already these Mutas go into town. They could very well clean up the entire mineral line. We have a handful of Marines that are going to get stimmed and force these units out. But that's actually a pretty decent blow there dealt by TLO.
Picks up a couple of SCVs, but as I mentioned, with this huge map, the mobility of the armies gets very important. And I mean, if ThorZaiN wants to push out, which he's actually doing here with his mines and Marines, these Mutalisks are just going to be able to dart into the natural and do some damage. But ThorZaiN just very smartly leaves a bit of his Marines behind while pushing out with the rest of his army. So yeah, ThorZaiN is not just falling into the trap of dying to the counterattacks, but it's actually pushing out here. And well, TLO's creep, but it's not as amazing as I would have thought, as he only has four queens right now. Or five queens, actually, but
yeah,
still not six.
With those Hellions, you know, the thing is that TLO never really got the opportunity to get rid of them, so they've been really limiting the creep spread, keeping those, tumors from moving out across the map. And for now, at least, ThorZaiN is going to be able to set up shop here in the mid of the map and just rally units, continue to build up that force. In the meantime, however,
Mutas are
in
going
the
yet?
Natural, we have the Mutas jumping in.
Just picks up a couple of SCVs and the missile turret, but they're going in for round two right now, and it looks like Marines might not be enough. But this is a great opportunity for ThorZaiN. He should just be pushing with his main army into the third base of TLO and trying to do some damage with the Mutas over here. But might we see a base trade right here? What's going on, really?
It does look like TLO is setting shop up here in the natural. That missile turret, however, the second one following it, he's going to get the cancel on that CC and force a handful of Marines back. Nicely done here. He's got to be careful about not flying over them. Just barely reacting in time there, TLO. He's going to get caught between a rock and a hard place. There are too many turrets. He picks one off, and now he's going to be on top of the production for ThorZaiN. In the meantime, at his fourth base, Banelings, Lings, plenty here to deal with the push coming from ThorZaiN.
And I'm just looking at the structures tab, and I'm just completely amazed. 18 spine crawlers for TLO. How often do you see that in a Zerg-based turn? He just goes for such a huge amount of static defense, and this just goes to show that he just wants to counterattack for these Mutalisks. He wants to put some pressure back while just be able to stabilize in these four bases with a huge amount of static defense. So, I mean, TLO, he's playing really, really smart at that right now. I don't know what to say.
Yeah, some decent damage inflicted, but both of these players maxing out now, so we're going to have to come to blows here, Mr. Bad Example. We're going to have to see something thrown down. And who's going to come out on top in the end of it? That's what I'm curious about. It's already TLO. You know, he's managing to get a pick here and there. He managed to get
the Bane Link counterattack here.
He feels merciful, I suppose. Lets the medevac live.
I mean, the Marines are pushing back the mid disc here, but it looks like TLO is just going to go for it.
Yeah, mid of the map already. The Link's kind of closing the distance. There are quite a healthy, there's quite a healthy count of mines out on the map, however, for ThorZaiN with a good spread as well. So it's going to be very difficult for TLO to get in here and take this engagement. The mines are waiting. The Overseer is just behind. And these Mutas, it's on cooldown. Able to get in there.
Yeah, the mines are quite able to get off there. But actually, you can see that ThorZaiN is just like 40 seconds to get the 3-3 from completion. So if ThorZaiN just wants to stall, and I think TLO just wants to go for it before ThorZaiN finishes 3-3, but because 3-3 Marines, as I said, I mean, it scales so well with upgrades, so ThorZaiN just wants to stall right now, but I don't know, does TLO want to go for it? He's sending a huge amount of circles to the top left. I have to doubt this. Is it a mistake?
I'm not quite sure if that was a misclick or not. I mean, that's basically the majority of his army. He's still got the static defense back home with a handful of Lings and Bane, so he could really, you know, prolong this engagement. Already great connection here from these Bane Lings.
Oh, it's just
going
to be a huge counterattack from TLO with a massive amount of circling. Is ThorZaiN going to be able to respond to this?
This is going to be very tricky here. ThorZaiN already going to be forced off his third. He's got those links going to work. The mine has been triggered already. It is not going to blow these ones up. However, there is a second mine. It gets the majority of the units. And the run by and the natural at least gets cleaned up for now.
So the Mutas at the third base, though, with the circling reinforcements. I mean, TLO, with a massive amount of static defense, as well as pushing it through with his Mutas, he picks up the third command center. And while all this is going on, Adrenal Glance is done. C3 is going to be done, as well as Cadence Plating, and six Ultras are on the way. I think TLO's got this.
Yeah,
I mean,
this
he's got
fantastic.
The late game, and he's got the armor.
He's looking very solid here, TLO. He's already forced ThorZaiN on the back foot. ThorZaiN not really able to accomplish anything at his fourth base, just kind of sitting there at the bottom. But all of those Spine Crawlers, the Banes and the Lings as well, have bought enough time for TLO to hunt down Thorzane's fourth. It gets picked out of the sky, and now TLO is just going to be ruling the roost.
Absolutely. I mean, securing four hatchers so early, and with all these Spine Crawlers, he's been able to fuel this counterattacking style to the late game, and now he has a lot of ultras on the way,
the
as well as the Crackling Sand, the Infestors. I mean, I don't think ThorZaiN can do it anymore. He does some smart dropping, but with the Ultras, the Circles, the Overseers, I mean, I think TLO's got too much.
Yeah, TLO's able to react to this in time. He's going to go ahead and get the defenses set up here in the main base. Repel this attack. ThorZaiN will have to lift off and take back, well, I mean, head back home as the Mutas are currently hunting for the remaining medevacs out on the field.
I mean, ThorZaiN's definitely giving up. He has a third and a fourth commander that's floating towards the bases, but he just needs to stall until he gets his economy up again, because right now he's down 40 supply.
This is looking very hairy indeed. There's no doubt about it. TLO putting up a solid fight. ThorZaiN as well. They're not giving up. They're giving no mercy. No quarter. And we do actually have, well, you know, TLO regaining control of the middle of the map here. Something we haven't seen in quite a bit. ThorZaiN going to be forced back and forced into his characteristic style of the Spoon Tear. And he's going to be looking to defend and try and buy time.
And as we talked about, the mobility advantage actually with him. Ultra transition from TLO, actually, I would say go to ThorZaiN right now with the medevacs and the Marines, but dropping in the main base doesn't manage to pick up too much and actually goes down. So right now, I mean, TLO had the mobility advantage earlier, but right now with like 10 Ultras on the field, he has the army advantage as well. So, I mean, TLO has, I think he's ahead in like every aspect of the game, so I don't know what ThorZaiN can do to bring us back.
His economy not doing too hot either. ThorZaiN not really sitting on a bank. He's got quite a bit of gas, but not too many minerals to work with. He drops around a mules though and shoots right on up there. So he's going to be able to continue cranking out units. It's whether he can keep these bases established and whether TLO will allow him to continue. As for now, TLO massing up here outside of ThorZaiN's third. It looks like he wants to go ahead and make a play for the fourth though, splitting his units up.
12 Ultras, if he flanks this properly, it's going to be huge. There's a big amount of Marauders for ThorZaiN, but is it going to be enough?
They're going to close the distance, and again, TLO going to give a little bit of ground, but it doesn't look like he wants to go ahead and make this play. No Fungal able to connect, no Fungal able to hold these Marines down, and it is going to force ThorZaiN right up into his natural. TLO splitting everything up, however, he's going to go straight for the fourth. The cancel is forced,
the SCVs! Wow. And 11-3-3 Ultras, do they actually take damage? I don't think they do. With like six armor right now, I mean, even if ThorZaiN has a bunch of Marauders, it's not going to be enough, I think. TLO is just pushing through.
Yeah, TLO so on top of everything right now. He's just forcing ThorZaiN back up into his base. He's maintaining this 50 supply lead. And for now at least, there's just a handful of Marines. They do. These are hero Marines, man. They're going to have a plaque for them up in the academy. But, you know, killing an Ultralisk is not something a single or two Marines can talk about very often. But they will force this Bane to cease mining. They're going to clean everything up. And TLO just looks to be in full control right now.
ThorZaiN is actually going out. Outside is naturally trying to poke in a bit, which is quite smart, having 8 medivacs. He can heal up the damage done again, but I mean, he has a drop towards TLO's 6th base, but that means, like, ThorZaiN hasn't even established a 3rd base, and TLO is the 6th bases. This is, I mean, I don't know what ThorZaiN can do right now.
Yeah, as far as income is concerned, you know, we can tell at the top here, thanks to UniSL's unique graphics, we can see the income, and as far as ThorZaiN is concerned, he doesn't have a whole lot to work with here. Only 400 minerals right now coming in, a couple hundred gas, compared to the whopping, 1K gas and 1,100 minerals for TLO. So TLO can afford to give away a couple units here and there. You can afford to trade units for ThorZaiN's army, but ThorZaiN can't afford to replace these units. He's very much on the ropes at this point.
One thing going for ThorZaiN, though, is that TLO has been going for the same unit composition for a long time, so ThorZaiN knows what's going on. He's going very, very Marauder heavy. Actually has a bunch of Marauders right now, which is going to be fine against these, like, Baneling and Fester Ultra. So, I mean, unit composition-wise, ThorZaiN is in a okay spot, but just being so far behind in economy, I think it's almost over. ThorZaiN needs to perform miracles right now.
He does. He manages to dodge a fungal there. Nicely done. A Bane is going to lend a hand killing that Marauder.
Absolutely. 5 infestors out right now. Has some energy for fungal, so I mean, ThorZaiN is holding at the top of his natural ramp, so TLO's not going to be able to kill him right now. But I mean, it's not enough for ThorZaiN to hold on 2 bases against the, like, 5 base of TLO, and he's going to go for it right now.
TLO kind of poking forward, looking like he wants to clear up the units here, the mines at the bottom of the ramp. If he can get a fungal, this could be all she wrote for ThorZaiN, and he is going to force his way right up onto the natural. The fungals connect. They catch the units. Not an excellent fungal, but still getting the job done, forcing ThorZaiN back up into the natural, forcing him to give ground.
I mean, these soldiers with 5-3 upgrades, they don't actually take damage. They're just pushing through all the Marines from Mars. Even though ThorZaiN's micro is excellent, it's not going to be enough. He drops into the main base, but even if he holds, what's he going to do with, like... I don't know what's going on.
These are hero SCVs he just picked up, man. These are SCVs you want them to fight for you the next day. I mean, they're going to get cleaved to death right here and now by these Ultras. I mean, already getting, wrecked. But TLO, I mean, he's morphing units in the ThorZaiN's base. ThorZaiN, I think at this point in time, mate, it's kind of time to just tap out and go into the next game, because honestly, there isn't a flying chance in hell that you're going to beat TLO at this point. And I think you've realized that. I just don't know why you're choosing to continue, seeing as how he's up in your main base.
You always want to hype it up as a caster, but this is a fantasy GG timing, actually.
This is the latest GG. There it is, the GG of the well-played come out. And TLO taking game 3 of this best-of-7 series.
That's really big, actually. TLO being able to pick that up. I think ThorZaiN was in a good position, but TLO just playing so smart. I mean, just going for a huge amount of spine crawlers. At first, I questioned that decision to go for a lot of static defense, but just seeing his counterattack of his style with the Immunolisk, with the Serglings, I think finally it worked out really well.
We saw the perfect example of that. ThorZaiN, you know, we'll take the 3rd base that's right about here. You know, ThorZaiN was never actually able to make it up that ramp. He had units parked at the bottom of it the entire time, and while the mutas were working on his natural, while they were darting about the 3rd, the main, looking for openings, he couldn't actually make it up there because there were Ling, there were Banes, and there was like 6 spine crawlers. So TLO was just sitting there being like, well, you know, please enlighten me, sir. How are you going to kill me here? How are you going to kill this base? Demonstrate it. And ThorZaiN just couldn't.
Absolutely. I mean, ThorZaiN did his best at putting up some big 2 base pressure, or like 3 base pressure, but I mean, TLO was just able to hold and securing a 4th base that early. I mean, that was a great showing for TLO, obviously, but just, we gotta remember that Whirlwind is a, as you said, it's a Zerg map, and Now loading into Derelict Watcher, I think ThorZaiN's got to be a lot more comfortable in this map.
Yeah, and a 1v1 map as well, you know, not as big. Definitely a bit more opportunity here for action between these two players in the early game and the mid game as well. So we'll see how TLO decides to play this, if he's going to go for any kind of aggressive early play, or if, you know, he's going to play things a little bit slower here, a bit more to ThorZaiN's tune. But spawning in the top right corner of the map already, our Terran player representing EG. It is going to be the Swedish Hope in this match, ThorZaiN. And there we have him. He's chanting a mantra to himself right now, trying to get back in the zone, regain confidence, as his opponent spawning in the bottom left corner as our blue Zerg player representing Team Liquid and hailing from Germany. It is TLO.
There he is, looking good as ever.
There he is, and he looks focused. He looks very intent on ruining his opponent's day. We'll see if he can pull it off here, but already, guys, cross spawns. I mean, there's no real options. It is kind of cross spawns. It's a 1v1 map.
Well, yeah, pretty much. You can say that.
There's not a whole lot to change things up, but already ThorZaiN's going to go ahead and throw down that, that supply depot at the top of the ramp, so indicating he wants to set up a wall to start things. We'll see if he decides to go CC first, as he has practically, I mean, every series, every map so far.
Yeah, went for the Reaper expanding one map.
Yeah, there you go.
But did very little with the Reapers. I mean, like two Reapers, six Hellion Spanish, pick up like one Queen and two Serglings, which is obviously terrible. So he's not going to be able to go for the Reaper right now. He's just going to go for the Command Center first, which I think is a fine choice right now. On this map, I mean, TLO has shown that he doesn't want to do anything too crazy aggressive, so I would actually like ThorZaiN to throw this up on the low ground, because, I mean, he knows TLO.
Why not?
Is TLO going to 6-pool in this game? He's not, I mean. But he's going to go for it on the high ground, which shows that, well, ThorZaiN has a special style of as a pro gamer, and he just wants to be safe.
He does, that's the thing. ThorZaiN does as ThorZaiN wishes, you know what I mean? Like, he's just going to stick to what makes him comfortable. And if putting the CC on the high ground makes him comfortable, makes him a happy human being, he's going to do that.
Absolutely. I mean, he wants to be safe, as I said, and here is the scouting SAV, actually, which is a weird choice when you go for the commands at the first. You generally want to get in all your minerals you can, mm-hmm. but the scouting SAV is on the way, which indicates that he might be thinking that TLO is doing something a bit cheeky here. If he can spot an early gas guy through an extractor going down from TLO, it's going to be really huge, as he can predict that it's going to be a quick speed and some roaches and some mainlings, maybe like it was in game two, but he's not going to be able to find anything so far. But this SAV actually indicates that, I mean, ThorZaiN is not feeling too comfortable in, he's feeling comfortable in a late game scenario, but he wants to know if TLO is going for something weird off of two bases.
Exactly right. He just wants to get that scouting information. This is confirmation. And, you know, this is the one thing. This isn't a four-player map. This isn't a massive map like Red City or Whirlwind, where, you know, it takes time to figure out where your opponent even is before you can start with the aggression. This is a two-player map. TLO could very well be trying to pull something where he gets up in ThorZaiN's face right off the bat. ThorZaiN sending that SCV out confirms the fact that TLO is playing tried and true standard games, and he's going to be fairly comfortable going into the rest of this map here, as and he just kind of continues powering up on his side.
Absolutely. And there's the factor going down for ThorZaiN, so everything looking very standard so far. What I was not a big fan of ThorZaiN in the last game is that he went for the second and third barracks before the engineering base, but he did not put down a lot of pressure off of two bases, off of two or three bases. So, I mean, if you go for the other barracks, you kind of have to make them worth something instead of the engineering base. So I would either like to see some earlier engineering base in this game, or I would like to see the second and third barracks going down with a lot more pressure put on early.
Yeah, it's curious to see as well, seeing as how it is mentioned that on occasion ThorZaiN, in a fit of madness, will go aggressive and will actually try and do some damage early on. You know, that's when you actually try and check and see if he's feeling all right, but it does look like he's healthy, he's sound, he's hale tonight, and he's just kind of sticking to the tried and true again. Looks like at the 3cc play.
Absolutely, it's going to go up to the third command center. And yeah, as I said, it's going to be really telling now if he puts down engineering base or barracks right now. Doing some beautiful microdecks with pulling away the mules from the minerals, which is always fun to see. Doesn't want to mine out the main base too fast.
Mid of the map, please.
That just goes to show you how...
Thank you very much.
How high level the micro of this player is.
He did the hatch cancel. That is so cool, TLO.
Wow.
This is the sort of thing that blew my mind the first time I was watching it on his stream, where he actually pulled this off, and I was like, I have to do that the next match I play. It is so cool. Going to get a little bit of a jump, you know? Just gets the drone out there, gets the hatch out, gets the cancel, and then drops the creep tumors on the little bit of creep that's there from when the hatch dies. So that, hey, he gets out here, he gets a bit of an earlier thing, and these two Hellions that are supposed to be denying that early creep spread, all of a sudden they're like, well, I quit.
Absolutely. I mean, I was talking about ThorZaiN and cool micro with pulling away the mules, but talking about cool micro, I mean, canceling the hatch to put on some creep tumors, that's just awesome. And actually, we can see here a lot of circlings as well. It's a Baneling nest on the way for TLO. You think he just wants to go for a circling Baneling bust?
Or he might, in fact. You're right. I mean, he's got the third base going down here, however, so he's got his options open, TLO. We'll see how he decides to commit.
He went up to 40 drones, though, and he's just producing circlings right now, so... I mean, I think TLO is going to be aggressive, but I don't know how successful it's going to be against like a lot of Widowmines and Hellions. I mean, it's going to be really tight, this.
Yeah, this is quite a few units actually making their way out here on the map for TLO. He's trying to hide the fact as well, sending them towards the lower. ThorZaiN, unfortunately, just going to stop his Hellion short, perhaps sensing that something's amiss, but no. Will be forced back to the mid of the map, and TLO is going to go ahead and get right on his, on his side of the map, unmolested.
Well, and this is just going to be a big three-base Baneling. Not an all-in, but at least an attempt to do some damage here from TLO. ThorZaiN has two Widow Mines at his natural base. If he's able to burrow them in a good position down at this ramp, he's going to be in a good position, but he's not having them burrowed, he's just having them unburrowed at the top of his ramp. He's not paying attention right now. He's not expecting anything at all like this. Is TLO going to finish the game right now?
This could be disastrous. There's already the bunker drops, and already we have these Banelings making their way in here. This SCVs gather up. We could have massive detonations.
Wow.
And there we have it. The Banes connect with the SCVs. Goodbye, natural mineral line.
A big, wow, two big Widowmine connections actually there. But TLO is just rallying in 24 circles at a time. And ThorZaiN, he doesn't have a chance right now. It's just a big rally of circles going in, and I think it's going to be GG, man. I think TLO's got this.
He's so close. He's on the very brink here. He's managed to morph more Banes, and they're making their way up the up the main ramp.
Oh,
but the star
so
point doesn't land in time. And now, again, okay, he decides to go ahead and stack a bunch of Banes on those. I think he's just kind of doing what he wants at this point, TLO. He's got so many Banes and Lings, and no way to stop them getting in here into the main. The lone medevac spawns, and it's going to lift these Valiant Marines, but it's for naught. They are going to get cleaned up. The SCV is doing battle now, and ThorZaiN on the brink of having to tap out.
Wow, TLO morphing Banelings in the main base of ThorZaiN. He's just pushing through, and SCVs are going down. Adams are going down, so GG TLO takes down this game. And he's really close to winning right now. TLO just shows that, yeah, this aggressive, creative style of mine, it kind of still works.
Ah, very close, very cool. Exactly right, man. He takes him by surprise already with the hatch canceled to get the creep out and then just catching him completely by surprise. It really did come down to whether the Hellions were able to spot those Lings making their way out of the base or not. And unfortunately for ThorZaiN, luck of the draw this time, he pulled them back just a second too early and didn't get that crucial scouting information out.
Absolutely, but I just think that the one micro play that could have saved ThorZaiN is if you had those two Widowmines burrowed on the ramp, and TLO would not have been expecting that, just rolling in with Banelings and they would have get blown up. That could have been a completely different game, but ThorZaiN didn't have them burrowed, didn't really pay attention, and I mean, yeah, TLO just pulled through in that game, and if he wins this one, it's going to be 5,000 Swedish kroner to Planting Trees, right?
Planting Trees, yeah,
exactly.
Right. There you go. So we'll have, I wonder how many 5,000, like how many trees you buy with 5,000 crowns. Like how many seeds that is, because he was talking about the billions of trees planted here.
Yeah, it's certainly ridiculous, like what, 1,000 billion trees or something?
Yeah, so are we buying like a bunch of seeds then? How many seeds do you reckon you can buy, tree seeds?
I mean...
Or do you have to plant saplings? Do they go out there and have the children slaving away in the heat of the day under the sun, planting one little tree after another in the field? Do you think that that's what's happening?
I think that might be actually what's happening, but TLO, is he actually supporting child labor? What do you think?
I mean, if a kid's paid fair,
then it might not
be. Then it might be all right. Maybe. But no, we frown on child labor. It's a horrible thing. Nike, you should feel ashamed. But guys, we're loaded into the map. We're going to be able to get this potential final map of the series underway here, as TLO is currently up 3-0 in this series. However, his opponent spawning in the top right corner of the map, the Terran player and the Swedish Hope, it is EG's ThorZaiN. And there we have him, focused as always, continuing with the mantra chant, and we shall see if it makes a difference here in this potential final map of this series. His opponent spawning in the top left corner of FrostLE, representing Team Liquid and hailing from Germany, it is Liquid's TLO.
I mean, just going into this game, as a Swede, I kind of feel like we had three Swedish players and one German player in this tournament, and just if the German would win, I would just be kind of ashamed. So I just gotta root for ThorZaiN right now. And if there's anyone in the crowd rooting for ThorZaiN, I mean, I wanna hear you, I wanna hear you for Sweden. I mean, let's defend this title here in the King of the Dome at Cosmonova. I mean, a Swede gotta take this home, right?
Yeah, Swede will take this home. I wanna hear it from way up here in the heavens from where we're at. And I'm not sure if I heard anything. I did take my headphone off, but I didn't quite hear anything. So guys, not quite up to snuff, but we'll see if ThorZaiN will be, as he's going once again for the command center first play.
Absolutely, command center first on the high ground against the 15-15 of TLO. Completely standard. We'll see if ThorZaiN wants to SCV scout again, and yeah, he's actually going to be able to SCV scout, which is, I mean, in the last game he didn't see an early guess from TLO, but he still went for the Baneling Bust, so the scout didn't pay off. However, on a four-player map, it's a different story. You kind of want SCV scout just to know where your opponent are. However, ThorZaiN is going to be scouting in the wrong direction.
Yeah, this is a little bit unfortunate here, and he's going to waste a little bit of time, but as soon as he sees this Overlord, doesn't look like TLO is going to give him the opportunity, though. Pulls it back in the nick of time, spots where ThorZaiN is, gets that information, and makes a slow float for the Highlands. In the meantime, ThorZaiN, he's going to take as long as physically possible to figure out where TLO is at this rate.
Yeah. As long as physical possible, that's exactly right.
I mean, he's having to go all the way up to down to the bottom. He's going to go across the map, and then he's going to go back up to the top before he even figures this out. As we do have the Overlord making its way here, they may cross paths, and this may be an indicator for ThorZaiN. This may show him perhaps a little something, save him a little time. Doesn't look like it. Nope.
No, ThorZaiN is just going to... Yes, you said it's going to take a lot of time until the scouts TLO, but I don't think it's a huge deal. I mean, TLO has not went for the guests anyway, so... Not any huge tells in TLO space right now, so not usual that ThorZaiN scouts last, but still not nice anyway. ThorZaiN is going for just the same build as he's done in all the other games. He's going to go into the Quick Factory. And, I mean, do you think he's going to do something crazy to switch it up, or do you think he's just going to be comfortable in the macro game?
I feel like ThorZaiN is one of those guys who gets the bit between his teeth, and he's like, I'm going to make this work. I'm going to play my game, I'm going to do my game, and I understand the mistakes that I've made. Perhaps this was just a fluke this last game. Perhaps my Hellions just barely missed the Lings as they were making their way across the map. It shall not happen again. I will make my plan work.
Absolutely.
I can see this going through ThorZaiN's mind. At the same time, I can see a whole bunch of expletives that we shouldn't be saying on the stream as well. So, you know, what's going through ThorZaiN's mind? I don't think we should know. You know, we got to give him a little bit of privacy. We're not the NSA after all.
Absolutely. I mean, we should. We're not any stupid Americans right here. We should just be...
Well, I don't know. Present. But,
Well, maybe. That's stupid anyway.
It's all good, mate. It's all good. I can cheat. I'm a mutt, after all. I'm half French, half American, so it's all good. I can take my French side right here and be like, nah. Yes, these stupid Americans. They are horrible. They are stupid. They have their desserts. They are up in their ass. This is horrible. But, no. I will focus on this game with my horrible French accent. And in the meantime, in the top right corner of the map, we have ThorZaiN currently macroing up. He's going for the third CC. He's going for the Hellions. He's
you
going to have
back,
the Rosti Toasty, yeah?
Rosti Toasty, je beaucoup, muy bien. Oh, no, that's Spanish.
Muy bien, that's Spanish.
maybe I shouldn't be trying. I shouldn't be showing off a French here for all you viewers.
No, I think we should like probably die in a fire for, well, at least I should for my poor attempt at a French comedy there, but it's all right. I'm sure some people may deliver later.
Well, I mean, you just did the accent. I mean, I actually tried to speak, but I wasn't able at all.
I mean, as far as things are concerned, guys, in the match right now, we have TLO going for his standard build. He's got the two Evos on the way. He's gotten the Overlord speed, so he's going to have that additional scouting information that grants him. As far as ThorZaiN is concerned, on the other side of the map, I mean, this is basically, they've had that gentleman's agreement where they're going to sit on each other's sides of the map. They're going to sit on each side and be like, I'm going to make SCVs. Well, I'm going to make drones. Well, okay then. You go ahead and get that economy up and running. You go ahead and start gathering those minerals. And we'll meet in 15 minutes time in the middle of the map and see who's the bigger man. And both of these players have decided to do just that.
Absolutely. Let's see who's the bigger man, who's the biggest Viking. Something to note, though, is that ThorZaiN, as I've been talking about, he's actually went for barracks number 2 and 3 before his engineering base again. So, I mean, he's going to have a lot of marines earlier, but he's going to be quite far behind at upgrades, actually, with TLO going for his evolution chambers pretty early. So, I mean, ThorZaiN is going to be in a good position production-wise and economy-wise, but upgrade-wise, he's not going to feel too comfortable.
No, and a couple good Baneling connects could be all she wrote here for ThorZaiN. He's going to be have to be a little bit careful here as TLO. He's got the Ninja Lings up here spotted up at the top of the map. And he does actually know that the third base has gone down here with this Overlord placement. Unable to deny it this time, unfortunately for him. He couldn't drop that creep, but still, the information is worth something. The Hellions are here. There's a lone Marine. There's a lone Mine. More than enough to clean up this little Ninja Force of Lings. They do get the SCV before they die. A horrible, painful, fiery death. But still, TLO's got the information.
Absolutely. TLO is able to pick that up. We have the Lair on the way right now, and with the spawn position so close, I think it's a peculiar choice to go for the early Lair, as the Mutalisks with the Spire and the Mutalisks are not going to be effective at all, I mean, seeing how the spawn positions are close, but there is the Spire pretty early, so I mean, it's going to go for Mutalisks, even though, I mean, the mobility is not going to be too important with so close rush distances.
That stutter step is a thing of beauty from ThorZaiN, clearly demonstrating that he has mastered the art of controlling Marines. He decides to go in for round two. He's going to get cleaned up quickly, picking those up in that medevac. And for now, at least, ThorZaiN doing his damnedest to keep TLO's creep at bay. Does not want this getting across the map. The mine, however, manages to catch half of those lings. The Hellions are going to get the other. And, well, you know, some blows, these are more like the opening jabs of a boxing match right here. Some blows, you know, exchanged, but no real damage done for either player.
I mean, you could say TLO is throwing away Zerglings. But anyway, he's just so far ahead in workers, he's going to go up to like 82 workers right now, which means he's just in a great position when it comes to drones. And, well, ThorZaiN's going to be able to roast a lot of Zerglings right here, but TLO has the fourth base on the way. I don't know if ThorZaiN has scouted this. He has not. And, I mean, ThorZaiN needs to get out on the map and get some map control because, I mean, if TLO just gets a macro freely, you know what happens.
Yeah, he overwhelms you. He overruns you, and ThorZaiN should know this. He should know this fact, but for now at least, he's content to just take control of this El Naga Tower. He's going to poke out and actually pick off this queen. Oh, barely picking him up in time. Nicely done there by ThorZaiN. Quick reactions. But he decides to go ahead and sack one of those Marines just the same. He was saying, well, you drew the short straw, and you're going to get to die today. And there you have it.
There's 12 Mutas as well as the Circle Fire attacks, level 1 on the way. And the reason I'm not a big fan of this on this map and with this spawning position is you can just see how close the bases are from each other. That, like, compared to Whirlwind, where mobility is super important, it's not going to be that big to still be on this map. So, Mutas are not going to be great, but, I mean, even. But ThorZaiN hasn't scouted it, so.
That was like the most unlikely situation ever. Slow Banelings walk up to a pack of Hellions and blow them all up. How often do you see that happen? Unfortunately, ThorZaiN, you know, he had his Hellions on hold position, and I guess he was distracted elsewhere. Didn't pull them back in time. Loses that one tool in his toolbox. He's not going to have those to keep a little bit of map control in the top of the map. But we do have the Mutas out on the map now. The reaction from ThorZaiN, drop the turrets.
Absolutely, and when it comes to timing pushes in this game, it's going to be a little bit weird because TLO is actually going to be heading upwards for a while, so plus two is going to be finished in 10 seconds with TLO, which means it's going to have a great timing window in like 1 minute until ThorZaiN's plus two finishes. So TLO is going to be heading upwards for a while, which means ThorZaiN, he doesn't want to go too aggressive.
No, he doesn't. He, you know, very much living up to his name, the Spoon Terran. I don't know how that even came to be. I mean, it's like he spoon you to death, I suppose. It's a very slow and painful thing, unless you go for the jugular and then spoon's as good as anything. But he has taken his sweet time right here. He's continuing to set a very big minefield here at the middle of the map, spreading them out well, making it so very difficult for TLO to engage. TLO, in the meantime, however, he's going to go ahead and morph those Overseers. He's got a healthy number of Mutas out on the map. He's got the Lings. He's got the Banes. And he looks like he's setting up to take a fight here.
I mean, I don't want to be boring, but everything I've talked about is like upgrades right now, but upgrades is just so important when it comes to Marines, and it looks like ThorZaiN is going to be able to stall until the 2-2 is finished, and with 2-2 Marines, it's going to be able to push this back, and yeah, it's going to be like 10 seconds, and they're actually done, so now I think ThorZaiN can push in, and now is his timing window.
Mm-hmm. And he's going to find that TLO's waiting with open arms. TLO is going to have his units right here waiting, and he's already going to see it. There we go. The scan is going to go down. For everything it. Is revealed, and TLO goes forward just a bit. He's
so
flying
many
the Overseers through, and they're going to draw a lot of the mine fire. The Marines are going to get cleaned up, and good Baitley connections are actually going to inflict massive damage to ThorZaiN, but will it be enough?
Well, look at these Marines reinforcements from ThorZaiN. Looks like they've been able to push back, and that was so many Overseers. It was like 13 Overseers or something. I've never seen so many. But ThorZaiN is pushing back, and with so many Marines, I mean, I think he's going to be able to do it right now.
That was
TLO
very sick.
Something too strong.
Yeah, great control there by ThorZaiN, able to spread out, spread his units. The Banelings couldn't get those massive game-ending connections right then and there. And again, ThorZaiN present right here at the tower again. He's got the vision. He sees those Banelings morphing. That is not the issue here for ThorZaiN, at least not for now. He needs to make sure that he can keep these Marines alive. He's already planning the Marines. Nice snipe there in the middle by the Mutas, picking off one mine. The second mine has been dropped. Unfortunately, it is not triggered. And it's the dance of death right here, the dance of doom between these two players. One mine, one Baneling could seal the deal right here and now.
ThorZaiN is just reinforcing, producing 10 Marines at the time, which means that TLO is not able to be aggressive with the Sorgling's Mutalisk. This looks like he's going in for it right now. Oh, he's going to go for it. There some huge Baneling connections. It looks like the Mutalisks are going to be enough. ThorZaiN does not really have the Marine count he needs to.
He has to be so careful, though. There are quite a few Mutas here, and they're actually managing to get with the Marines, but again, the mines, the Marines, the reinforcements coming in here from ThorZaiN. His macro is impeccable. There's only 10 supply difference, and after all the Overlord sacks, all the Overseer sacks, well, you know, thrown into the mix here by TLO, making sure that he can clear up those mines, he's supply blocked. So this is delaying his play quite a bit here. TLO having to slow things down as best he can.
I mean, ThorZaiN and TLO are just trading armies in the middle of the map, but this means that TLO's fourth base is just going completely unpunished. ThorZaiN doesn't even know of its existence. So, I mean, if ThorZaiN would just send like one Marine down there to scout it or send on the drop, would be huge, but he's just going to push through the middle right now.
Yeah, this is a little bit tricky here, and already TLO having to give a little bit of ground. He's not too pleased about this. ThorZaiN, though, has to be careful. He's starting to get onto enemy creep here. He's going to go ahead and throw one drop, and it's actually going to find that fourth base location unless TLO can put a stop to that. But the Mutas, in the meantime, looks like they're kind of floating about the mid of the map for now, at least. Oh, no, he's just actually taking control of the second Zelnaga Tower.
Plenty of fortress at the fourth base for ThorZaiN. I'm a huge fan of this. I mean, even if ThorZaiN's engagements go really bad, he's going to be able to pull back to his fourth base to the plenty of fortress and defend. At that static defense.
Mutas, they're going for the backstab. Oh, they're looking for the supply line. They're looking for the supply train.
But
they're going
so
for the
marine
fight. But they can take this. There's enough here. They could try and clean up the supply. And ThorZaiN. Oh, what that mine connection, though.
Oh, and on the mine here.
Oh, this is catastrophic. The mine is going to hit.
Oh.
Four Mutas left here for TLO.
TLO has lost a huge amount of Mutas. And at TLO's fourth base, the Marines are pushing through. The fourth base is down for TLO. I think ThorZaiN is just hugely ahead here. And I think he might have done it.
Yeah, he might have found the way back into this match here. ThorZaiN, he's looking. He's taking control of the mid of the map, and he's starting to push out here, push back this creep. But slow and steady is the name of the race here for ThorZaiN. He loves to take his time. He's establishing his own fourth base, and for now, not willing to throw anything away. He's letting TLO hang himself.
ThorZaiN just scanning the main base, so there's no hive on the way, so he does not need to be worried about the 3-3 coming in for TLO, but he has 3-3 himself, so this upgrade advantage is going to be huge for ThorZaiN, and he's going to be pushing in through with Marines, Mines, and with his 4th base with a 5th command center on the way. He's just going to be reinforcing with such a huge amount of Marines and Mines.
Yeah, 3-3 Marines, they just shred everything in their path, and this gets more and more difficult. TLO's on a timer here. He needs to either inflict massive damage to ThorZaiN, or inflict massive damage to ThorZaiN. There's really no two ways about it. He needs to get up in ThorZaiN's face and just take a completely one-sided fight, because otherwise, he is going to get overwhelmed. ThorZaiN with the upgrade advantage, and the fact that Marines cost just nothing but 50 minerals, he's on four bases now. He's dropping mules left and right. He's got the money, ThorZaiN. He's richer than Wall Street at this point.
Something like that. I mean,
he's richer than Bank, that's right.
Yeah. Well said. I completely agree. It's Mutalisk, though. Oh!
Hey, I mean, banks come to mind. They're thieving bastards, a lot of them, you know? So when I think, you know, there's a lot of money on the line, I think a bank. It just comes to mind. And banks have now become entities, obviously. They're persons, so.
What do you think about ThorZaiN's bank, though?
There you go. ThorZaiN doesn't have, well, ThorZaiN actually got it. He's got a few minerals on the line. He's got quite a bit. So he should be able to do something with this.
And, I mean, TLO is going to be trying to break through here, but again, loses a lot of his Mutas, but actually been able to... I mean, he has no detection, so he's not going to be able to pick up any Widow Mines, so... Tilo is just trying to push back ThorZaiN, but it's not going to be enough. I mean, this Spoon Terran, he just has too much.
I'm glad I'm able to entertain production so thoroughly. This is great. I can hear them laughing still. I mean, as far as things are concerned, ThorZaiN is just taking his goddamn sweet time at this point. He's really just pulling TLO apart. TLO, I mean, he's down in supply. And when you're running with Ling Bane Muta, you want to be up in supply because you're going to need to sack units to take the fights. You're going to need to sacrifice some of your army to get in there and deal
that
damage.
He's just
going
to YOLO it, man. But he's just going to go for the counterattack.
You know, I like the choice of that word, mate. That's a good call. He is going to YOLO it. He's formed the YOLO hit squad. They're making their way right over here to the fourth base. They will deny it here. The third, rather, or the fifth, rather, for ThorZaiN, but they're going to deny it. So many medevacs, however. And ThorZaiN, in the meantime, just pushing left and right. He's taking the top base. He's taking the bottom base. And now TLO on the ropes. He may very well be tapping out in a minute's time here.
TLO's putting drones to fight again. 3-3 Marines, a terrible engagement there. And he's trying to push through on this fourth base. But there's two mines. There's a planetary fortress. I don't think TLO's going to have enough. It looks like ThorZaiN's going to be able to push through. Take this to a game number six.
Oh, man, he's all over it. ThorZaiN, there we have him. Keeping his cool, man. He looks like an iceberg right now. He is just so in control of himself. We can tell, maybe a little bit blinky, but still very much focused, very on top of his game, and he is bringing this back, this series back right here, right now, as we have a bit of the smile coming out of him as well. If we can take a look at TLO, I'd love to see TLO's reaction and see, however enjoyable it is to watch ThorZaiN munch a banana. TLO, where's TLO? There we have it. Fantastic. Slow pan. Building the tension. TLO. Are we going to see him? There he is.
Oh, there he is.
TLO. Looking a little nervous.
Yeah.
Looking like he's under duress here.
After the first game or at the second game, he just went over to the ThorZaiN's booth, like knocked his back and just said, well, I'm in control of this, pretty much. That was his body language says. But right now,
I think so.
He's sitting and seems almost a bit nervous. I mean... Does he know what to do right here? He has been throwing it up, or he's been throwing in some weird stuff in two games, going for the big roach play in game, let's see how good memory I have, like game three, and then for a lot of banelings, and a big baneling bust of three bases in game five. But, I mean, Yeonsu is the next map, or however you pronounce it. You think he just wants to go for...
It's Yeonsu LE, though, mate. Get it right, please.
Yeonsu LE. Yeonsu, is that right?
What do you make of the balance on this map?
The balance?
Yeah, what do you think of this map as far as the TVZ is concerned? Because honestly, Yeonsu, I haven't seen massive number of games played on it myself, so I'm not too familiar with it.
I mean, I think it's actually fine. I mean, you can take fourth bases quite easily, so it's good. And it's actually very good for Reapers as well, so...
It's very good for Reapers. Okay, well, maybe we'll see ThorZaiN actually change up his game and go
Hopefully.
Reapers! Oh my god, take a page out of Show's book. Are we going to see that, though? We'll find out as spawning in the bottom left corner of this map. He's got two games under his belt, two notches in the leather. It is our Terran player, our Swedish hope, the Viking, ThorZaiN.
Hey, Sverige!
Yeah.
There we have it. Again, focused. Sneaky as snake. In the top right corner of the map, we have our Zerg player, hailing from Germany and the prisons of Krakow. It is Liquid TLO.
Yeah. Looks.
He actually looks kind of, like he's not quite sure what's going on. He's kind of scratching, his chin. He's like, what the hell just happened on last map?
Looking around.
I mean, he's one game away from securing this series and securing 5,000 kronos for the trees.
Exactly.
A lot on the line right here.
I mean, if you haven't been able to check everything out, this is actually really important. This series is going to decide whether 5,000 kroner is going to go to planting new trees or protect old ones.
That's so exactly right, man.
That's what's on the line here.
I feel like ThorZaiN's is really like the city lover, sort of charity. It's like, I'm okay with, trees being there. I just don't want more of them. So protect the ones that are there. Look after them. Make sure that they grow healthy. But no more, please. And TLO's is like, I just want green everywhere, yo. He's like the hippie in this equation. He's like, green everywhere, more trees. TLO spends all his day on our trees.
That might be true. And I guess this has to do with like the countries they come from. I mean, ThorZaiN is a Swede. when you travel through Sweden, there's just gonna be trees everywhere. I'm fucking sick of trees. But I mean, I don't know. I haven't been in Germany a lot, but if you travel around in Germany, I mean, I don't think there's a lot of there as much trees as in Sweden, at least. So
no, I don't think so. I don't think so. It's not really their style, is it, Germans? It's against the rules, and when it's against the rules for the Germans, they, you know, they short circuit. They can't handle it. So, oh wait, look at this play coming out here from TLO. Is he actually gonna go for a quick play? Let's see. What are his minerals at? He's got 300 minerals. He's gonna go for a quick three hatch.
Oh yeah.
First time we've seen this actually in this series. So this is actually TLO throwing up a bit of a curveball here, looking to take a bit of an economic advantage here in the early game.
Absolutely, and not only is it gonna be a lot of economy, but it's also gonna be a lot of production and a big amount of creep spread from that third base. So TLO's is gonna take a lot of advantage here of ThorZaiN's really greedy play. I mean, he's been going for the same build in almost all the games, so.
Yeah, ThorZaiN is a bit predictable. He's like a papier musique, you know, like I don't know if you can say that. It's like the music paper, you know, sheets of music. It's kind of predictable where he goes. You can kind of read him like a book. Right.
I don't
so
get it.
ThorZaiN, you can see him coming from a mile away. He does the same damn thing every single game. And as far as TLO is concerned, I think he's had enough of it. He's like, well, okay, I've tried the aggression. It's worked. It's failed. You know, I've had mixed results. So he's like, I'll try the greed strategy now. I'm just going to try and get ahead economically, or at least on par, and then carry it from there.
Absolutely. I mean, he knows what ThorZaiN's been going with for in all of the games and what ThorZaiN feels comfortable with. And actually, ThorZaiN did go for an early scouting SUV, but he did not see the early third hatchery. So ThorZaiN does not actually know what's going on from in TLO's position. So I think ThorZaiN is just going to go for exactly... I mean, ThorZaiN is just going to go for his normal build, while TLO is just, you know, he's just going to go for the greed.
The greed, man, the greed. I appreciate this from TLO. He's going to look like he just wants to crank out the drones. Nothing but the drones. He's got one spine crawler. Rather than make a ling or two, he's going to go ahead, make the spine, have that static defense down, and the Evo chamber as well. So nice thing to point out there. But as far as he's concerned, he's looking to get the drones out. He's looking to try and get as much of an economic advantage here in the early game as possible so that then he can get the jump on ThorZaiN. He can start cranking out the army and perhaps tear this Swede limb from limb.
Probably, I mean... Showing who's the big
Oh, wait, that is an interesting mark as well, actually. Let's see real quick. Where's TLO's gas? He hasn't upgraded speed yet.
He's just going to go for the upgrade, I think, as he has the Evolution Shaper done. Would be my guess, please. And ThorZaiN actually a very un-ThorZaiN-esque play here, just sacrificing his Hellions to do some damage. And I think he got, like, two drones but lost the Hellions, so might not have been completely worth it, but... Anyway, yeah, I think that TLO's gas save was just to get that early upgrade with the early Evolution Shaper. So
yeah, somebody needs to go and check ThorZaiN, see if he's feeling all right. You know, he has sacrificed units early on in this game. That is definitely not characteristic. As already, he's actually kind of darting up here at the third again. But still, queens are waiting. There are two of them here. We do have the five Hellions total waiting at the bottom of the ramp. We'll see if they decide to dart up here and try and inflict some damage or not. Great creep spread as usual from TLO. In the meantime, however... On ThorZaiN's side of the map, you know, continue... Oh, there we have the Roach Warren play.
Wow, the Roach Warren. Do you think this is something that's just like 5-7 Roaches to be defensive?
This is actually really cool.
Or is it this like going to be a mass Roach, big 3-base push? I think it's actually going to be like just massive amount of Roaches.
Yeah, it seems like that because he's working on the +1 carapace. It should actually... The +1 carapace should kind of come close with speed. So Lair's about to finish up in a couple seconds time. If he starts speed like right on the button... We could have, like, speed Roaches rushing at ThorZaiN in a moment's time.
And there
we go.
Wow.
This is so cool from TLO.
And with production of 3 bases, with 63 drones just mining, I think we might just be able to see a huge
swell of units.
Push.
Exactly right.
Absolutely.
We could see a huge swell of units coming out from TLO. He could have quite a scary army out here. And I can't say that ThorZaiN really has the units to deal with it. But then again, the last time that TLO went Roaches, he went Roach Bane, didn't have the best results. ThorZaiN was able to hold on somehow and stay in this game. We'll see if he's able to do it here again. In the meantime, on ThorZaiN's side of the map, I mean, he's cranking out the mines. He's getting those out, so he will have some area of effect damage to try and hold this push off. But what else does he really have to work with?
He has a lot of mines as well as a few marines, but the overlord speed is actually done for TLO, so this means the overseers are going to be really quick, but
I mean, ThorZaiN is just playing really offensive. He's just sending out his first Marines on the map, wants to take some map control, and this is actually not the right play at all, I think, versus a big amount of roaches. However, he is going to be able to see them early.
Yeah, exactly right. You know, there may be a bit of a warning here, an early warning for ThorZaiN, and allow him to prepare. We haven't seen any real... Oh, wait, one bunker going down, but I'm not sure if that's just standard or not. He's got... There we go. And it's just going to be part of the wall, so... No, not any real reaction out from ThorZaiN quite yet. I don't think he's quite spotted this, as the roaches are going to make it to the Zelnaga Tower. They're going to spot these Marines, but they're going to run right on by.
Oh, ThorZaiN has not seen anything yet. I mean, the roaches has just gone unchecked right now. Wow, this is a huge amount of roaches from TLO. Is he just going to be able to... Well, all these overlords are not from TLO. ThorZaiN knows that something is going on, but all these roaches, wow! With the Overseer as well, it's going to be able to kill the Wintermines. I mean... TLO is going to count the production facilities.
Yeah, he's going right on up into the main base. There's not a whole lot here. The mines get picked off. Lickety-split, and we have the Overseer as well there to spot the future mines. But already, these roaches, great split from TLO. He gets right up into the production line, takes out these reactors, and there we have it. TLO is up in ThorZaiN's main base.
40 roaches out for TLO. This is just a huge count of...
Yeah, look
Army
at the CLO.
ThorZaiN's pulling the SMEs.
He has to pull everything at this point. The mine focus fired immediately. We have the Marines. Oh. The Hellions are here as well, but the SCV is getting a good surround. They're trying to do as much damage as possible.
And
there's
ThorZaiN
quite a bit here for
ThorZaiN. This is just
the
so
Overseer
tense.
Is not in range. The Overseer is not in range. It's not going to spot it.
The mines. But there's another huge bunch of roaches coming with bait on GG. Well played. TLO takes the series. Wow.
Congratulations to TLO, wins 4-2 in this best of seven, takes out the series, and we see him make his way over here, shakes ThorZaiN's hand, pretty much the drive-by shake there. He's like, yeah, good job. ThorZaiN put up an excellent fight, but unfortunately wasn't able to hang on to the series, and we are about to hear from the victor of this tournament in just a moment's time as he walks suavely, debonair as always. TLO makes his way to the main stage. Give him a round of applause.
I can definitely appreciate the great play of TLO being able to just analyze ThorZaiN to pieces, see exactly what ThorZaiN is going for, and react perfectly. I mean, give it up to the champion.
Yeah, fantastic play here by TLO. Fantastic play for ThorZaiN as well. Just wasn't able to quite hold him the second, and it's going to be second place for him. But now we have trees. They'll be planted everywhere. TLO's charity of choice is going to get Zimbunnies.
Oh yeah, and after that I think we're gonna just leave it over to Queenie with the interviews, and man, just I'm so excited to hear from TLO.
Well, welcome back after an incredible series, TLO. Like, my mind is a little bit blown, I have to say.
You're welcome.
I mean, where do you even begin after a series like this? I mean, why not from the beginning? You took a very quick first victory. I mean, did you expect the game to be this close as it turned out to be?
I mean, I always try to go into a match with a very open mind, right? So the best thing is not to expect anything really, just, you know, have your plan in mind, stick to your mechanics, have confidence and try to read the game from the point that it progresses, see, you know, game can basically fork in a lot of different directions. You just need to, you know, make sure you take the right path and, you know, step by step.
Yeah, well, your army control has been immaculate throughout these games. I mean, there have been these crazy Baneling mine wars where one Baneling hit or a mine hit could have just turned the tides completely. I mean, is CVT a matchup that you've been practicing a lot? Because I know a lot of Zergs have been struggling a bit with that matchup.
Well, to be honest, I never specifically tried to practice CVT because it's just always stayed on top of all the other matchups. So I rather practice CVP and CVC at the moment because my CVT seems to be naturally good. It's always been my best matchup. TVC and CVT, back when I was playing Terran, has always been my best matchup no matter how hard I try to like improve my CVP or CVC. CVT always stays on top, so that's it.
Yeah, I mean, wow. And now that you've won this, I mean, Plant for the Planet is going to receive this donation. I mean, is there any other reason why this particular charity is important to you? Like, is there something that you would like them to spend the money for more specifically, like a certain project or?
Well, no, not, well, basically the ongoing project is just plant as many trees as possible. That's why I like the charity, because it's, many times charities have such complex agendas and such big operation that a lot of money gets spent on, you know, just administrating the money and the staff. So, because the charity is mostly driven by, you know, a simple goal, most of the money actually gets spent on the right purpose. That's why I like that. And yeah, that's great.
Well, it's been amazing to have you doing a charity event like this. So it's always a pleasure to have you in Sweden and doing events for us here. But I think that you would like to get your check now, I think.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you.
There is the big check. And just to counterproduce, we give him a check of paper so that he can plant new trees and get more paper. Exactly. It's recycling paper, exactly.
Yeah, at least
thank
that's
you very much for coming, TLO. And I want to thank all the other players for coming as well, of course. And I really want to thank our super professional interviewer, Queen E. Give her a nice hand. She jumped in. Our first interviewer, Ina, got ill, unfortunately, so she couldn't be here. We really miss you, but Queen E did a perfect job. Thank you very much, everyone, for coming. Did you enjoy the view of the game here? Do we want to see this happen more times?
Absolutely.
Perfect. All right. We'll invite you next time as well.
Thank
good luck
you.
In the IEM, man. All right. Thank you very much. And good night to everyone on the stream. And good night to everyone in Cosmonova. Bye. We love you all.